We're pirates now.
All right. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the second session of Alien RPG Chariot of the Gods. We're back, and all kinds of stuff happened last week. All kinds of bad things happened. So we're back to see if we can survive another week. If we can survive through Act 2, this is a three-act adventure. So let's see if we can survive. People do die. Just so you guys know, there are NPCs that you can step in as.
Oh,
that is a real threat.
That's good to know.
Death is a threat. It can happen. It will happen. Stress will eventually get to you. I think that'll probably kill you sooner.
But yeah, I'm racking it up already.
You guys let loose all kinds of strange things on the ship. Why don't we go ahead? It's weird. My phone just turned off or reset. It's bizarre. Why don't we go around and we'll let I'll do the usual introductions. People can plug whatever they got going on and also do a rundown of your character. So we'll start with Jen / Rye.
Hey, everybody. I'm Jen. I have a channel that we stream on every Tuesday, Pixel Prowler. We just played Remnant about 30 minutes ago.
Yes.
We did so good again. That's okay. On Saturday, we're playing Mutant Year Zero on Grim and Perilous Gaming with Matt being our GM. Pretty sure he's going to kill us with the rot.
Yes, it's all about the rot.
And I'll be playing Piper Proudfoot, just the one foot.
Yeah.
Tonight, I am playing technician, Kayla Rye. She's 23 and better, and she knows it. I'll be trying to get rid of my stress tonight, hopefully.
That's right, get rid of stress. And these guys all have new agendas. We're not going to get into their secret. So they had agendas in Act 1. As we go into Act 2, they've all read and now know their agendas after everything that happened took place last time. I'm going to be right back. I'm going to step away for a moment. So continue to do the introductions as I step away. Next, we'll jump over to Leland. And I will be right back as we do the introductions.
Cool. Hi, Matt. Oh, hey, everybody. I'm Leland or Lee or Leopold the Just, whatever. Leopold, I don't know, too many names. A social media consultant for a few different companies, Zombie Orpheus Entertainment. They make films and live stream as well. Work for Fantasy Grounds, run their Facebook page, and also work for another channel called Audio Dungeon. They play on Wednesdays. At 7:30 p.m. It's a pretty cool show. It's like a D&D 5e homebrew with some mini games at the beginning. It's pretty cool. Definitely worth checking out. But yeah, you can find me at Leopold the Just on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all that stuff. Anyway, basically just play on this channel a lot. And today I am playing Lyran Cam or Cham, whatever. Chom, whatever.
Tram, Chom.
I'm going to say Cam. I'm going to say Cam because it's like Kim, right? You know, chemistry, but like Cam. But anyway, I'm a cargo. Shut up. That's what I'm going with. I'm a cargo hand. I know, exactly. It is today.
Yeah.
I'm playing a cargo handler, also a technician. But I think I'm better at heavy machinery than she is. No, I've got a flamethrower. That's probably about the only damn thing I'm going to be really good at this whole time, now that we've ran into giant aliens. Yeah, I'm pretty excited. I'm really just a good-hearted, you know, corn-fed southern boy.
In space. All right.
In space.
In space.
Always in space. Yeah. Okay. Tram. All right. Over to Jeff, a.k.a. Wilson.
Wilson, yeah. Tonight I'm playing Wilson. He's the company liaison, all the crew's favorite man of the hour. He's already feeling the stress for the night, and hopefully we can relieve some of that. What's going on? Not too much, even though it does sound like they will be playing Dark Astral soon.
Yes,
here.
Finally.
And it sounds like Daniel's been putting quite a bit of little new stuff up on the Discord channel. So I think that's going to get they're working on kind of a revamp or something right now. Definitely what it sounds like. So that'll start up here soon. Hopefully that'll be a good time. That's all I got going on.
All right. And Wilson, what did you tell us about Wilson? He's your favorite company man.
Yeah, so favorite that's company guy. And it's so far it's been not too stressful, I don't think. I think we're all still getting along for the most part. Maybe not the captain's not too happy with him, but we'll see.
You're just an asshole. I mean, that's yeah, about as much as it's... you're not like a traitorous guy I want to murder with my flamethrower yet. But
yeah, wait till he pushes one of you in front of danger to get out of the way of danger.
Right, then...
Wait till that happens.
So far, you've been agreeable as far as... that's pretty much
that's
the way that my
all part
characters...
of the plan.
Yeah, I'm sure it is.
Okay, and Evan...
All right. I don't have anything going on besides playing with you guys, and I will be awesome. Joining Enemy Within in the next few weeks, hopefully, with my man Griggs. But in this game, I'm playing Captain Vanessa Miller, who is the captain of the Montero, which our crew will probably, hopefully, get back onto at some point without dying.
For sure.
Yeah, of course. That umbilical AP.
We'll totally make it.
Yeah.
But yeah, she is not the biggest fan of Wilson because she's kind of over being kind of a corporate in the industry and wants to try and find a way for her crew to have their own ship where they really don't have to have someone above them that they take orders from.
There you go. Very good. All right. I just linked the book itself over on Amazon via our affiliate link. If you guys are looking to get this, you can pre-order it over on Amazon. It is available from Freely Games, who makes awesome, amazing games. So double go check it out. Let's do a recap of what happened last week. What happened in Act 1, everybody? How did we start? You came out of cryo sleep. That's how we started.
All right.
Yeah. You had some food, and then what happened?
We were wandering through space on the, or was the ship broken down? I can't remember.
Your ship was fine, but you got mother gave you an alert that there was something nearby.
Yes,
there was
an
a
alert
stress call,
the stress beacon. Yes, and so we found like a hull, like a floating ship, and
nearly
we just. Yeah, and then our protocol is to go and check for survivors, but that's the kind of like the tertiary concern, I guess. The main one was to scavenge, right?
Yeah, mother let you know. Okay, so your three priorities. Mother told Miller this. There you go.
Take samples, yep.
Recover scientific data and samples from the USCSS Cronus.
Yeah.
To scavenge. Escort the salvaged Cronus to Anchorhead or another Weyland-Yutani facility. Or three, all oh, and three, save crew members on the Cronus.
All right, yeah. All right. And we docked with that. We all kind of stuck together as a crew. We're investigating. We were finding scratch marks on the walls.
There was a body with its head blown off by a shotgun.
Yeah. It was crazy.
so far we've stuck together.
Yeah, and then they found a body and something was moving around, and I can't remember who was it. Was it Rye that was messing with it, or was it
Wilson?
Oh yeah, it was Wilson. There was like you guys were down where the to get the air flowing again in the ship.
Yeah.
There was like this huddled spacesuit in a
corner. That was our first priority. Good priority, by the way.
And Wilson took a little closer look, was looking at the spacesuit, and all of a sudden he noticed it move, and he unloaded his shotgun on it.
Yeah.
And this thing
got a little
stood
hasty.
Up, this big, like, 7-foot creature, alien creature, stood up and shrieked.
It was a cat.
And ran into the ventilation system. But nobody else saw this. They heard it scream.
No, of course not. Yeah.
And they saw just like the tail end of something go into the ventilation system. But Wilson unloaded his shotgun on this thing, and it is now somewhere in the ship.
Mm-hmm.
You guys also went to the science labs, did you not? The science and medical labs? What did you find there?
Syringes of some black liquid.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some samples.
That's about it, right?
A couple metal containers.
Some eggs and some.
Some eggs? You found some jars with some little alien fetuses
floating
in them?
We also found a hallway with a bunch of eggs in it, too, right? But leading into that, don't we have plans to destroy that?
Anything creepy.
That's the captain's orders. Anything creepy.
Captain's orders. All right. I'm down, Cap. You got it. I'll set this shit on fire. No problem.
Oh, wait a second. We got to redefine creepy here. Okay.
Yeah, right? What's creepy? So you guys went through that. You went through the science
Wilson.
Quarters. It's all on fire now.
What did you find in the science quarters? There was one that was burned out completely, wasn't it? Something had lit a fire in the middle of it.
A body was burned up. We did find a security card.
That's mm-hmm. right. In a pile of black ooze and goo.
Yeah.
And we found out that the black syringes are a cure. We think, or maybe
right,
not.
Right, because some of their crew came out of cryo, right?
Mm-hmm.
At the very end, or it seemed like near the end there.
Yeah, Mother came on and let you know that the bodies were, the people in cryostasis were thawing out, so you went in there to go meet them.
And don't they have isn't there a mother already on this ship? Is that the mm-hmm. one that we
Every ship has a mother. Yeah. It's like the...
Okay, that's the one we were using.
The main
right?
computer.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. We did successfully burn off all of the goo that was on the thing.
The air scrubbers. So you got the air flowing again. So you guys are out of your suits.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay.
Now, are suits like something that we can carry with us? Like if we're not wearing them?
You could. Like you could still be wearing them and have your helmet off and carry your helmet.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Okay.
It's kind of cumbersome, though. If you remember what the suits looked like in the movies, they're like quite big and bulky.
I'm just curious, because if we're trying to leave, we have to put on the suits again, so that's why I was thinking about it.
Yeah, definitely going to have my suit like attached to my back or something, I guess, or however it works.
Or we can try and find some more.
That's it.
Yeah, they have to have some. I know Wilson has his little tablet with all the schematics of the ship. Yeah. I would imagine there's more suits in any kind of airlock.
I scooped up a bone saw, you know, for a melee weapon. Right. In case I want to duke it out. Some sort of handheld bone saw. Right. I got out of the medical lab.
Yeah, Chan's up front.
I've cued the music.
I like it.
Oh, no.
So, we left off. So how did it end, guys? We're like, we didn't even talk about how this thing ended.
Sorry, it's
been
the
doctor started to turn into an alien, and we tried to kill it.
Not
but it
turn
did.
Into. Remember, well, it started busting off its face. All of a sudden, his eyeball flew out, and who did it hit? It hit someone. One of the crew members. Is it Cham?
I think so, probably.
Yeah,
yeah,
the eyeball bounced off you and rolled under the cryo chambers, and all of a sudden, this little his mouth started being pulled open from the inside, and these little hands and arms started stretching out from its skull. Oh, the doctor's skull.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
And he was dead.
Blood was spewing everywhere, and this little alien creature popped out and shrieked at you, and you guys just unloaded on this thing.
He was wearing a man suit, and he ripped it off.
Did we kill it, or did it run?
It escaped in the vents, obviously.
Like all the other creatures we fought.
The little guy got away in the vents. Yeah, it scurried away.
And that was where we left off.
That is where we ended. So, now we're going to pick up. You guys are there. In the cryo room, I'll go over to the schematics of the ship so we can see where we are at. To follow along, you are down on cryo. There we go. Cham was our guy that we were using as our point of reference. By cryo 1
there.
That
was a taking point, I think.
And how many people like were out when we got there, like total, like crew members?
I'll tell you what. How about I move you over here?
Oh, no. Battle map.
Sweet. I like a good map.
So, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them there in front of you. They just witnessed this thing happen. They're freaking out. They all back to one corner of the room. They're like, oh my god, oh dear god. No, this isn't happening. He was supposed to be inoculated. So Dr. Cooper died. So Dr. Cooper is done and gone. So there's four remaining. He's a pile of goo on the floor.
And the rest of these... No, I was just... The rest of them all looked fine, right? I mean, they
that's
were freaking
out. That's
what
I was going to ask. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It seems like that's what I remember.
Are they kind of freaking out?
Yeah, they're freaking out. This thing's run away. They're like, dear God, he was supposed to take his... his inoculation. What we all took it before we went to cryo. What the hell's going on here? And John's, who's the captain, who identified himself as a captain, he wanders over to Cooper, and he starts going through his belongings, and he finds the syringe in his pocket, full. He's like, he didn't take it. He didn't see what happens. Did you find anything while you were in the ship? Did you take it? Here, take this now. It'll save your lives.
We still have one that we had, right?
You do have one that you had.
Okay.
Right. So it's another syringe full of that black goo substance. And Cham, you're the closest. He holds it out to you. If you haven't taken it already, here, come here. Let me administer it to you.
Hold on now. Hold on. I'm just going to let out a huge whistle with my fingers. I can't actually do it. But just let out a loud whistle and go, all right, now, y'all damn, calm down. All right? If we are going to survive and y'all are going to live, we ain't gonna do it by freaking out, all right?
If you want to survive, you need to take this. You just saw what happened to this, to Cooper.
Yeah, but something's happened to us.
Well, how long have you been here? How long have you been on our ship? What's going on? What is the status? What year is it?
How long have we been on this?
You've been on the ship for a couple hours.
Just a couple hours now. We're just fine. Listen, we've encountered a couple of things here on the ship with claws that y'all might want to watch out for.
Oh, dear God, still alive?
There's more than one it. There's many its.
Oh, Johns lets out a big sigh. The rest of the crew wanders over. Clayton, in particular, looks very interested in what you have to say.
Listen now, you tell me and my friends what the hell you know that we don't know. Right the hell now.
Yeah.
Before I put you on the business end of this flamethrower. I ain't fucking around. I've done seen some messed up shit tonight.
Now what happened to Cooper that made him turn? Was he bit John, or he eat something or
John says, well, he obviously didn't take his injection. And he lets out a long sigh and he goes, listen. We sat down on LV-1113 and we explored some ancient ruins. Quickly, Clayton, who's behind him, she pipes in, she interjects, and she goes, "It was an archaeological mission." And okay. he looks at her, he shoots her a dirty look, and he goes back to the group of you guys. He goes, "Hey, our science team collected some important artifacts," and he does air quotes with that. And we inadvertently brought back some spores with them, and it infected my crew with these neomorphic motes.
What the hell's neomorphic mean?
That's whatever the hell that thing was. Whatever the hell that thing was, it popped out of Cooper.
Oh.
We also know we brought back some egg sacs, and we know they're dangerous. We know that they carry these damn things.
Well, why didn't you safely store these egg sacs at least? Because it seems like there's a heck of a lot of them down in this hallway down here. They didn't spread.
Well, while we've been sleeping, obviously they've spread. We thought we had it contained.
Yeah. Bunch of dumbasses.
What are we doing? Are any of us any kind of medical? I don't think any of us are we? Our crew.
I have a couple points.
Oh, well,
is this location defensible? Or what's the most defensible location that we've encountered, probably? What do you guys think?
That you've encountered? Oh, I don't know. You've been in a whole bunch of rooms.
Yeah, what do y'all think? Yeah.
Well,
or can they go? Can we send them back to our ship, or do we need to hold up somewhere with them?
You can try. He said. John's asks, "Is my ship functioning? Have you guys? Are we flying? What's the status?"
Sorry.
We are not flying yet, but we have turned on the power.
Where are we? In space.
The middle of space.
That sounds about right. We're not near a colony or anything.
Do we not know?
No, you guys are in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. We out in the middle of uncharted zone now, and it's kind of
supposed to take the Kronos back with us.
Yeah, kind of a little out of our element on there, but we have a feeling we can get back on track. But we were supposed to deal with this mess first, which is a big, much bigger damn pile of mess than I was expecting.
So, go ahead,
Flynn. Steps forward and he goes, I am also a doctor here on the ship, and I insist that you immediately inoculate yourselves.
Okay,
we found a cure that neutralizes these neomorphic growth things once they're inside you, and it turns it into an innate tumor. We all took it and we're fine. Cooper obviously didn't.
What is the time frame of needing to take it?
I don't know. I suggest immediately. You've been exposed to these things for a few hours. It varied with our crew.
Well, this doesn't inspire confidence. Let me just say that.
Hell no. Is there any way that we can check on, like, the credentials of any of these, especially, like, Flynn?
You could try. I guess you could try and access Mother, but now that Johns is awake, he is the captain of this ship, so Mother would react to him.
I'm going to look at whoever I think has the highest medical, if that's...
That would probably be Flynn. He is a doctor.
Well, no, on our crew.
Oh.
The people that I know.
Looking over their crew...
Fat goose egg.
To get an idea of them, Johns, he's identified himself as a captain. Flynn has identified himself as a doctor. Clayton, you can see, is wearing a Weyland-Yutani uniform. So you have a pretty good idea, Wilson, that she is also a company man. And Reed is dressed like a combat grunt in fatigues and stuff.
I'll say, Captain, what do you think on this vaccination?
Well, I took it, and I seem to be fine. I haven't been affected by these motes or anything. I don't have strange creatures popping out of me.
But you don't sound like no damn science to me.
Like, how did you create such a thing and then take it without anyone turning? I don't understand the timeline here. When we should be taking this. We've only been here for 2 hours.
Flynn recommends... Have you gone to the ship? Have you come in contact with the eggs?
I interrupt him and snatch it from him and just like, give me the damn thing and just stick it into my arm.
All right. Well, there's one of you who is level-headed. Unless
I ain't turning into no damn... monster.
Right, unless the rest of you want something bursting out of your head, I recommend we go to the medical lab and we get some more. I have some more syringes there with this substance in it.
Can I make my way over to Clayton?
Yeah.
Okay, like good enough? Is that
work? Yeah.
Okay. I'm just gonna kinda low tone ask Clayton. Say, you know, is this all on the up?
She nods.
Is Flynn, yeah.
She nods to you and she kind of steps.
Have you taken it? And I'm, yeah, exactly.
I've taken it. We need, but you know, I can see that you're a fellow company man. Yes. You know that we need to get this back. This needs to be brought in safely and securely to be researched.
Understood. Okay.
You know company protocol.
I do. Okay, I'm gonna come back.
Evil asshole recognizes the evil asshole.
Yeah, right. Hey, little devil horns in each of them.
Who has the other? I don't want to say antidote, but the other syringe.
I think it's Miller has it, isn't it?
Yeah, probably me.
Okay.
How am I feeling?
And I'll say, Captain Miller, do you think...
You're feeling okay right
sounds
now.
Sounds like we should go ahead and inoculate ourselves. Right, maybe we need to head back to the lab and get the other ones so all of us can.
I agree. I think I'll hold on to mine until we get to the lab and I'll take them together.
Understood. What's the grunt look like? Is he armed?
She's got a shotgun that she's loading and she's kind of leaning up against the machinery there and she's arming herself and loading her shotgun and cocking
it. Is that
it.
Reed?
That's Reed, yeah. Reed.
Oh, okay.
So are we all going together, Captain Johns, or what's the plan here?
Can you at least give us Reed for some muscle if we're not all going together?
Yeah, he turns to Reed and he shakes his head. Yeah. You can take Reed with you. We're going to go check out the bridge. Have you guys been to the bridge yet? Do you know what kind of shape it's in?
There seems to be electricity, but at least there was, but when before we turned it on, like a low power, but we didn't go there.
All right. Well, Clayton, Flynn, let's go to the bridge and take a look at it. Reed, you go with them and go get shots for everyone.
We got comms set up for everybody, or we ain't gonna be splitting up now without being able to talk, are we?
any other systems also do we need to be looking at?
Yeah, John's recommends. He goes, it sounds like you guys have the air scrubbers going. So that's step one. The next thing I'd recommend is we get the commery going so we can talk to one another throughout the ship. And then obviously the engines. You say the engines are online? If not, we need to get those back online. But that's going to require some external repairs.
Yeah, that ain't no problem here between me and Rye. But listen, you just need to tell us where the hell we got to go to do all that. That's all we need to know.
Yeah, you can go to the reactor core for the engines. Right. And the engines are outside. You're going to have to go to the engines, and you're going to have to repair those. Outside. The comm array, you're going to have to...
Where the hell's that?
You're also going to have to go for a spacewalk.
You're lucky I took zero-G mechanics for 5 years.
Both of them are spacewalks. Both of them are zero-G.
Well, that's unfortunate. Wilson doesn't do spacewalks.
You a little scared?
What I know as
look a little scared there when we mentioned spacewalks.
As a captain, if we were to tow something that it needs to have its engines on?
Yes, you would.
Okay. Fuck. So we need to be
anything that I could plug into to try to get the comms up.
You could maybe plug in an assist Cham on the outside who's gonna have to go out there and do some heavy machinery rolls and do some laser welding on all these different things to get them up and going. All
right. You can earn your money now.
Ooh. Wilson.
She earned plenty of money last session.
Shots fired.
She did more than all of us, I think. All you did was just shoot at something willy-nilly.
All right.
I'm saying is I'm not leaving here without some gainful motherfucking employment. If I have to go outside and help him, I will.
Don't worry, it's fine. As we're going to head out, I will walk up to Captain Johns and I'll just kind of, go towards his ear and say, "You owe us big time," and then I'll leave.
He looks at me like, what? What do I owe you?
Your lives.
All right, so Reed accompanies you. She's got the shotgun. Do you want her to bring up the rear? Do you want her in the front? What do you want?
Oh, she's in the front.
Yeah. All right, she's in the front.
Go get it, Grunt.
Yeah. Wilson's been with a shotgun in the rear.
Yeah.
So are you guys sticking together, or what do you want to do here?
We could split up.
You've got the captain and the others going to the bridge to assess the condition of the ship and what's going on. It's been recommended that someone go outside and get the communications relay and the engines up and running. And you've also been told you need to get inoculated, but Cham has already taken the
syringe.
I could give mine to Rye, and then me, Reed, and Wilson could go to the med.
Are you sure that what you have is the inoculation?
Mm-hmm. It's the same thing. It's the black syringe that we have.
It looks identical to what
it's the same color. No sense in doing anything.
I'm an alien!
Rye and I could go and take care of the engines or one of the mechanical things if someone wanted to go with us, we could do that. Or if someone wanted to go with the other crew, I don't know. If you guys want to stick together, we can. Or if you want to split up, we can. I don't know.
Well, we're in a little bit of a conundrum. We're, I guess, sort of in time is in the essence of the essence, but at the same time, we're already aware of many threats.
Why don't we stick together at least to go get the antidote?
Okay. And then we can watch you guys and take care of you. Okay.
Right.
Let's all head to the med lab or science lab again or whatever it was.
Yeah, it was the med lab that had all the stuff in it.
And okay, try to take our time and see if we can get the syringes.
You want me to take care of those eggs while we're in the hallway?
No, because he said the eggs are the cause of the spores. So what if they... before we take our injection. So probably inject and then we can do it.
Inject and then put our helmets on and then do it.
Yeah.
You guys head to the stairwell and you make your way down to the next level. The crew follows with you because they're going to the bridge, which is on the same level as you. But once you guys go down the stairwell, they go north and you guys go south to head over to the med lab. So go ahead.
I'll tell everyone to put on their helmets now that we know about the spore thing.
Got it.
Okay.
Just to be safe.
So guys make your way back to the med lab. It looks like everything is just as you left it.
All right. Everyone?
Do you want me to do a rundown of what was in here again? You had vials. Let's see. In this room are two older generation Pauling med pods. One of them has its plexiglass tube splintered and shattered as if something broke out of it. The other is sealed and lit within. But the entire inner surface of the plexiglass is covered in thick, dried blood. There is a row of large specimen jars. Floating within two of them are two small alien creatures. On the far shelf is a smaller specimen jar without liquid containing the same fungal nodes that can be found in various locations of the ship that you guys have already encountered. On the desk next to that is an open metallic urn. Four organic-looking glass vials are inside the urn. Three of those are intact with some kind of black liquid within them, while the fourth is cracked open and empty. So you took one of those, right?
Yeah, I thought there was six.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to think.
Or was that the science? Was that where that? I thought that's what maybe it was in the science lab.
That might be in the science.
Yeah.
Oh, there is. Under the desk is a med case that contains six syringes full of 26 Draconis strain derivative, the cure for those infected by the neomorphic motes. So,
okay, there they are. So there should be five in there because we took one.
So you guys enter the room and Reed, she's got her shotgun ready and she starts kind of poking around and shoving things in the gun. She's like, what the hell is this? I told them to leave these things behind. Look at these damn things. What do we get ourselves into?
So, hey, Reed, is there anyone else in cryo, or are you guys the last of them?
No, we're it. What? Okay. She walks over to the two med pods, and she goes, what the hell happened here? Look at this. Something busted out from the inside.
You know, I appreciate your enthusiasm, but we're kind of in a life or death situation, so if you poke everything, I'm sure we will all die.
She says...
Down a couple notches.
Yeah. She with that she grabs her head and she starts complaining of a headache. She's like, oh,
do you
cryo sickness? Sorry.
Okay.
It's affecting me.
All right. Well, I will grab the antidotes and I will pass them to Rye and Wilson, and I'll get an extra one. And so we'll each take one, and I'll have an extra one just in case.
Yeah, you guys inject yourselves with them.
Yeah, I guess so.
Everybody injects themselves with
everyone is, I am, yeah.
I mean, I already did it, y'all. Come on.
So the three remaining all inject yourselves with the black goo.
Yep.
Including you. So, Wilson, you're doing it. Right.
Yes,
yeah.
I just got a flu shot recently, so like my muscle pain is starting to kind of creep back up. You're talking about this. I'm just like, what the hell is going on?
It's just too real.
I know, exactly.
Bear with me here.
That'd be so messed up if they're like, it's the cure, and it like literally turns everyone to aliens.
I've already thought of that.
Bear with me here. I'm just sending a couple messages on Discord. Watch your Discord for a message to some of my players.
No.
Oh, no. I closed Discord. You can send it to me through Zoom. I'll open it up on my phone.
And that's one. And... ooh, the secrets.
We get different things? That's weird.
Yeah, I'm sending different messages to different people. All right, so check your Discord. You got some messages.
I didn't get anything. Am I supposed to get one?
If you're supposed to get a message, you got one. I'll tell you what.
We're not cool.
No, it's just it ties just into certain things.
So I don't die.
There are secrets among the crew.
I don't like secrets.
Okay, so
just to amp up the tension going on.
No,
here.
I love secrets.
Everyone's taken their medicine, and now it is time to try to turn on the engines, correct? Or maybe communications first.
Okay, yeah. Oh, well, the plan was to stick together while we did this. Then I believe we were going to discuss the plan further from here.
So,
do we want to stick together here?
Is communications?
It's going to be on the outside. You need to go outside and repair both of them. Both these things from the outside. The
array
and the engines.
So can we get it from... What level do we need to be on? I guess that's the question.
To get outside the ship? go back to the top, like through the, you'd have to get out through the hatch.
Like where we were on A?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's all make our way to the first floor, and we will, I guess, try to cover you from the outside, or from the inside to make sure nothing spooky. Okay.
Spooky happens. Yeah, it's... Yeah.
You guys all just play together so nicely. You all tag along together, huh?
Yeah.
No, oh, it's like the perfect place for someone to shove you out into space.
If anything happens to me, you owe me a job.
Don't worry. We have plenty of jobs.
Yeah, I mean, well, I guess the... I don't know, Rye, you want to go for a spacewalk, or you want me to? I mean,
we could both go together, and we could be on the outside or in the inside, making sure nothing comes up.
Yeah, I mean,
look at him volunteer me go outside. So friendly.
I was just trying to discuss it, you know. But all right, well, all right. Yeah, well, I guess we're going outside then.
I better get a raise for this one.
As you guys are discussing like what the next course of action is, you see that Reed, she's starting to get like agitated in the corner over by the pods, and it's starting to really get to her, and she turns around and she's got the shock and her eyes are all wide. She's, Did you all take your medicine?
Did you take yours?
Yeah, I took my medicine. And she takes the butt of her shotgun, she smashes the glass on the that's remaining on the one that's broken on one of those med pods, and she cocks her shotgun. We're not going to make it out of here alive! And she turns a shotgun on the group of you.
Oh!
Listen, whoa, hey now. You go ahead and put that down a little bit.
Are we like in initiative? Or
we're going initiative. She's turning her shotgun on you guys.
What a... I don't want to say the word.
Do I have time to reach my signature
poop
item?
Face. Is that the word you didn't want
to
say?
What a poop face. To reach your signature item? She's turned the shotgun on you. She smashed the remaining glass. She's smashing out. She cocks it. She's like, we're not going to make it out of here alive. We're going to take you all with me. The company's not going to get what's in here. And she pulls her shotgun on the group of you.
We're just doing initiative dice or cards?
Forbidden Lands, where it's cards. So you guys each draw a card, and that's going to dictate where you are on the initiative check. I'll deal one to each of you. Deal one card to all players. What? The deck's out of cards?
Yeah, I didn't get no card.
Recall all?
There's no cards in the deck.
Yeah, I see that. We'll deal one card to all players. There we go. Okay. So it goes from lowest to highest. So you want the lower number.
Oh.
So you can go ahead and shout out what you have. I got a zero? Zero's a thing in this? That seems silly.
Isn't it 1 through 10?
Yeah. Well, I'm going to take a new card.
Get a 10, please.
Unless the zero is 10. I didn't set this up. Let's see this.
Take the 10.
Has everybody filled in their numbers? Because I'm going to...
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'll take the 3. Zero's got to be 10. Zero's got to
take it.
10 the way he set it up.
Bro, I got a 1?
Big 3 out of my face.
No, give me that.
Big 3. Yeah.
I'm trying to send it back to the deck. Recall all.
You shouldn't let me move it around then.
Shuffle. All right. So the lowest number goes first. So Rye, you get to react first. All of a sudden, she's got this like space madness in her eyes, and she's cocked her shotgun, and she's pointed at the group of you. Who needs to know how combat works in this? Who's not played a free league game yet? Because combat's the same in all of them.
Oh, well, I have not, but...
It's the same as Mutant Year Zero, Jen. So yeah, we've got range bands here.
Basically two actions.
That's what those lines are. You've got two actions. You got a move and you got an attack. There are charts in here. If you look under charts and tables, there's an actions chart, and that'll show you what you can do in combat. You can do one slow action, one fast action, or two fast actions in combat. There are range bands. That's what those lines are. So to move over here, you'd be within short distance. So if you're shooting or anything, but if you want to attack them with melee, you'd have to be engaged. You'd have to move two range bands to engage them. So right now you're one range band away. You could fire your gun from here, no problem. And yeah, one fast and one slow. And that's really how it breaks down. We can go over it in greater detail, but I think all of you, with the exception of Jeff, have played a Freely game before.
Right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So if I did the fast action, I could do the fast action aim and then the slow action attack or something.
Yeah.
Okay. What does aim do?
I think it gives you a bonus die to your...
Is it not listed on there?
I'm having trouble seeing them.
No, it just says prerequisite.
Oh, aim shot plus two. Yep.
Yeah.
Sorry. I forgot there's three pages of this cheat sheet.
Yeah, I forgot I had that.
Oak just showed up and say, hey, anyone died yet? Soon, Oak. Soon. We're in our first combat encounter.
He's such a good friend, right?
Crazy crew member with a shotgun.
That's positive thoughts, Oak. Positive thoughts.
Yeah, come on.
This didn't happen to us, Oak, when we played this, so this is new for these guys to have a crazy
Since I'm going first, I'd like to try to go over there and maybe knock her out.
Okay.
So would that be combat?
It'd be combat, but so remember, it's one movement to get into the same range band as her, so that's short distance, and it'd take two range bands to get next to her in the same round.
Ooh.
So you wouldn't be able to use your slow action then.
Let's see. I guess I'm gonna get out my weapon if I haven't already.
Okay, draw your weapon. What are you carrying? I know everybody took a weapon. You guys are all very, very
Bolt gun.
Bolt gun.
But, is that the same as the DV-303 bolt gun?
Sure.
Okay. I'm going to try to shoot her in the leg then. See what happens.
All right, you draw your bolt gun and you try to shoot her. Is that a long range weapon? You're shooting into short range?
It's short.
It's a short range weapon?
Okay.
Yeah.
So I need to be in the same band, right?
It's, and you're medium range, so it's a minus one to your dice. If you look at the ranged fire modifiers, so you're at medium range right now. If you were in the same band as her, that would be short range. So you're firing from one range band away if that's a short range weapon. So it'd be a minus one to one of your, say, your skill dice.
Can I move her in first then?
Yeah.
Okay.
That is two successes. So, let's refer to the charts. You guys all have your cheat sheets that I sent you last week as well. It'll be in the chat, in the Discord chat from last week. Where. But there should be all the options on there for combat stunts.
Ooh, I would love to pin the pin read down. They need to make an immediate panic roll.
That's your range combat stunt? So, plus one to damage, swap initiative cards with opponent. Opponent makes a panic roll. Opponent drops held item or weapon. Opponent goes prone or pushed back. Or an auto fire only additional target hit. So you want her to, you want to cause her to make a panic roll?
Yeah.
Okay.
She's already pretty loopy right now anyway.
She is pretty loopy as it stands. Let me go to her character sheet. Boom, boom, boom. Where are you, Reed? Stress. Panic. 11.
Whoa, that seems awfully high.
What is that on my panic chart? Seek cover. You must use your next action to move away from danger and find safe spot if possible. You're allowed to make a retreat roll if you're engaged with the enemy. Your stress level's decreased by one, but the stress level of all friendly PCs at short range increases by one. Well, I guess you're not friendly anymore. So her stress goes down by one, but she's got to seek cover. Okay, cool. See, all of a sudden starts freaking out. Ah, the fighting back. I'm going to kill you. You must be infected. I'm going to take you all out. Cham. It's not her turn yet, so she can't dive for cover. So she's still there. She's just like throwing a shotgun around the air, flailing it around.
Take her out. Take her out.
All right. Cam is going to charge her and attempt to disarm her with his bare hands.
you just sighed. Wilson just sighed.
Damn, the good-hearted, corn-fed Southern boy with that loves his Mother Mary and then the Bible.
Yeah, you're gonna get us all killed.
Wants to try and save this lady. You're just like, why isn't he ripping her head off? Anyway, I'm gonna charge her and try and disarm her. Is that how does that work?
You got to go through two range bands though to get engaged with her, right?
Well, I want to just get engaged then, I guess.
Okay, you can move up and engage her. Yep. Boop. Just get right up in her business.
Business.
All right, Miller, you're up. Cham just ran up there, and it looks like he wants to throw down with her.
Okay.
Thrower is still hanging from the side, by the way. I don't have it in my hand. Like, I'm about to, light her on fire.
She's leveling her shotgun now to Cham. Stay away from me! Stay away from me! I'm gonna blow a hole right in you! You're infected! You're one of them!
No, I ain't. Now, listen. Calm down before these people behind me end up accidentally killing you. All right, sorry. Go ahead, Evan.
I'm gonna use my pull rank talent. So I can use my command skill to order another non-officer PC or NPC to force them to follow my orders. So I will point at Reed and I will say, put your shotgun down. We are not infected. We are human. We are not aliens. Put it down right now. So I need to roll command against her manipulation.
All right.
That's cool.
That is cool. Yeah, don't forget about those abilities you guys have.
That's a lot of dice.
One success out of all those dice.
40 dice.
And it's her manipulation she's going up against.
Yeah. My stress level increases by one.
Three successes.
Oh!
Nope.
She's like, you're one of them! You've been infected! You're gonna be the first to die!
That's my slow action. Let me see.
She gets some bonuses off that, doesn't she? For manipulation? What can she do with all those bonus dice?
Yeah, she gets two bonus.
So how do the stress die work then?
The stress die are like extra dice for you to roll, but there's also the chance of coming up with panic when you roll them. So it's like a good and a bad, because she got bonuses on them, which is good, but she also got no panic rolls on any of her stress die. So think about it, it's increasing your pool, but it also increases the chances of bad things happening.
How about this? It says target doesn't demand return favor. Maybe you could interpret that as him not being able to do that again.
Yeah.
It's just a thought.
It's not bad. So she's completely immune to your guys trying to sway her. She's convinced that you are.
And what does seek cover do if I use that? Like, what does that do mechanically?
You can get behind cover, and then it gives bonuses or like negatives for someone to try and shoot.
Okay, I'm gonna seek cover over here.
Sure, you get behind something. Okay.
Yeah.
Wilson, you're up. You've got this heavily armed Marine who's looking to unload her shotgun in your crew, or into the people.
Plan was to use the shotgun, but I cannot do that now. So
I mean, you could.
No. he's not that bad.
A good guy.
You have that ability to tell people to get out of, or oh no, they can jump in the way of harm for you.
Yeah,
I'm in there, buddy.
Yeah. I am going to, everyone's moving forward to take her out or disarm her or take her out peacefully. So I'm going to, take cover. And let me see.
You can get behind one of these tubes. You can get behind one of these machines here. It doesn't matter. You can go anywhere within that range band you're in.
Wilson, get away from me. Get away from me, Wilson.
Well, yeah, the two hate each other the most. Wilson comes on over and cuddles up to Miller.
Can I do this for take cover? I don't know how much movement I have.
Yeah, you can go anywhere within anywhere in the band. Square that you're on, this range band here, you can go anywhere within it that you want to get behind something.
All right. I'm going to come all the way over here then.
Okay.
And
I'll move this out of the way so people can see you.
Take care of, and I'm also going to take care of unneeded items, shuffle around a little bit. So I'm done.
Okay, she dives behind cover.
Do I get, with us being engaged, do I get like attack op or something? How's that work? No.
No. Nothing just like Forbidden Lands, that's one of the movement options is to disengage, but you're stuck within the same range band as someone. So she's still in the same range band as you. Well, she's now short. She's no longer engaged, but she can't like, she can't run over here. So she's still stuck in that area with you. So she dives behind these canisters here and she levels her shotgun at you, Cham. She's like, you can't stop me! You can't stop me! And she gets ready to fire on you.
Oh no.
What? What did you mean? What did you say?
She says, you can't stop me! And she levels her shotgun.
No.
Oh, a panic!
She hits you, but she's also going to panic. Let's roll her... What's her panic at? 10?
Do I have armor? I have 2
armor. 11 again. She has the same thing. So she goes behind cover and she loses another stress. Oh, that's good. That's good for her.
How does armor
work? Her.
So armor is the same as Forbidden Lands. You get to roll your armor dice to see if it soaks it up. I'm going to give it an extra point of damage. So her shotgun, what does a shotgun do for damage? Where's my weapons?
Probably 2.
3.
3 damage, so it's going to do 4 damage.
That's the one that I have, yeah.
So she levels her shotgun, fires at you, and it, bam, hits you square in the chest. So go ahead and roll your armor dice to see if it soaks any up. It soaks up none, and you don't lose any armor either. If you had rolled 1s, you would have lost points of armor. If you had rolled 6s, you would have eaten damage. So you take 4 points of damage, Cham, from the shotgun.
I'm at 1 HP.
I'm going to kill you all! You're infected!
Yeah, save the I know Marine. You are! Save the Marine.
And that takes us to Rai's turn.
Do see, something,
Rai. I see Miller's just, Rai, you're up there. She's behind cover. She'll get some bonuses to being hit.
So my DV303 does 3 damage and I have
it did 3.
Piercing.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
This is getting really
She's still
hairy.
Alive. But yeah, she's in her I forgot to roll her armor, didn't I? Did she wear armor?
Oh, y'all. Take her out. Now you say take her out.
Popped a fucking buckshot in my chest.
Yeah, take her out.
No, she's not wearing armor. You guys are lucky.
Lucky, huh?
I have to wait for you to be broken before I can help you, so moving on.
She's got 0 armor. She's got that shotgun still leveled to Cham. Stay away from me! Stay away from me! I'll put another one in you, I'll finish you off.
Shoot her.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead. Since it's a single shot, I need to reload it, correct?
Yes, you do.
Okay, so I'm going to reload it and take aim. Well, not take aim. I'm going to shoot at her again and hopefully
hit her. Yeah, so she's going to get a cover bonus here. So you're within the same range band, but cover... Oh, cover gives her an armor rating. So you still get to shoot at her, but there's going to be armor that's going to possibly eat it up. So go ahead and fire at her. Oh... Miss and roll a panic die, please.
Oh no!
So do you gain 1 stress if you roll that?
So you gain a stress if you suffer 1 or more points. You gain a stress, Cham, because you suffered damage. You gain a stress if you push a skill.
I should have pushed on that roll. I forgot.
If a member of your own crew attacks you, if a person nearby is revealed to be an android, if you encounter certain creatures, locations, determine the... So, no, you don't gain 1 for rolling panic. So you rolled 8, so that's 8 plus your existing stress of 2, so that's 10 total. You freeze. You're frozen by fear or stress for 1 round, losing your next action, your next point of action. Your stress level and the stress level of all friendly PCs in short range to you increases by 1. So gain 1 stress, and Cham also gets a stress because he's in short range. You start panicking, he's bleeding out. He's lying there. Oh, and you miss, and then you're like, shit, she's gonna kill us. She's gonna kill us all. And you start panicking, and you freeze up, and the champ starts freaking out.
No, that was her. That was her plus 2, by the way. It was a D6 plus 2.
Oh, was it? Oh,
yeah. So it's tremble.
Yeah, it's tremble. You start to tremble uncontrollably. All skill rolls using agility suffer -2. until your panic stops. All right,
get rid of that stress.
Yeah, get rid of your stress. Unfortunately,
hey, don't sound so freaking sad. I'm nearly dead.
Midnight is early.
You've done your job.
All right,
Grim Streamer.
So with my panic roll, did I gain 8 stress or just
no?
One?
No. So that just goes on the table.
One.
I refer to the table of like where that lands on the table. So.
Should be at 3, I think.
Gain a stress, and you're trembling now. You have a -2 to all agility-based rolls, so like firing and things like that.
Great.
Oak says, boo this, man. Yeah, you're right, Oak. I agree. Boo this. We got Cham down to 1 hit point. We'll see what happens. Cham, you're up. Speaking of which.
Cham's going to try and take the shotgun from her again.
You're going to get up there. Actually going to try this time. So yeah, you can engage her this round, and you're going to try to take the shotgun away from her?
Yes. Mm. And I can push twice because it's strength-based, and I'm badass. So.
They don't listen to the company, man, right?
2 successes.
So let's see here. What are you trying to do? You're trying to disarm.
Mm-hmm. So let's see, what is that? Close combat attacks done.
Close combat, she's going to
pull object from target. Yep, I can do it.
She's going to be able to attempt to resist that, so it'll be opposed strength rolls.
Can I? What if I push it? Does that allow me to get more?
You could try to get more successes, but you might also get some more stress and panic.
Yeah.
There's that chance.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
So you got 2 successes. Let's see what she gets. You want to just push it outright? Do you want to see what she gets first?
I didn't know if I could do it in that order. Yeah, I would like to see.
Or do you want to? You want to? I guess you'd have to choose now. Do you want to push it?
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and push it now, just to try and gather up some more successes. Just to make.
So you're gonna be -1 on your skill dice because you have a 6 on there, right? So you don't reroll that.
So when input value pops up, I can put -1 in, and that should do it, right?
I don't know. Let's try it. I don't know. It's a good question.
So I'm rolling 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It'll subtract from the black die or the.
It'll be from the black die.
The black, yeah.
Okay, so let's see. Oh, it worked. Okay. Ooh.
So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 successes.
Yeah.
Oh, she has 2 and 2 panic.
So that gives her 10 stress. Have a heart attack. Just die.
10. All right, so she just rolled a 10, which we've already had, haven't we? Freeze!
That's the freeze.
Freeze. And stress for one round. Lose your
shotgun at her, right?
So she, you grab her. And she freezes in place, and you snatch the shotgun out of her hand.
Yeah, I want to do it like slick. Just grab it and immediately turn it around, point it at her. And then say, I done damn told you we was going to accidentally kill you if you kept up this crap. Now just stop. It's okay. We're not infected. You're not infected. You have a damn headache. It's fine. I'm just gonna, basically, all I can say, I imagine, from my turn.
Okay. So, she seems unfazed by this. She's frozen in place, but it doesn't look like she's not backing down. Wilson, what do you want to do?
You skipped my...
Oh, sorry. Miller, what do you want to do?
You're okay. So
she's frozen, but I'm not ending combat right now.
Okay. I'm going to use... She's really getting on my nerves. I'm going to use one to like kind of... I'm going to try and... I mean, obviously this doesn't really matter, but try to move as my fast action, then I'm going to take a shot at her.
Sure. Sure, go for it.
Does she still get credit or bonus because she's frozen?
She's frozen, but she is behind cover still.
Okay, let me find. So it's just what ranged? Or do I do the...
So you get to roll, but if you hit her, she does have like natural armor that I get to roll.
Okay, let me see if this weapon worked. Oh,
so you missed.
I'm
look at that
push
weapon
it.
Button. There you go. That's what everybody should be using. It's got the damage on there and everything.
I'm going to push it so I can just reroll
it. Right? So that's actually near range. So you'd get minuses. Or no, you're in near range.
I'm in near.
Yeah, you're in near. You're good. You're good.
So I push, I just reroll again, like everything, right?
Yep.
Oh, I hit her.
That's a hit. You want to, I guess you can't push it.
I don't think I can push it.
So you hit her. Shot rings out, and
well, I have, it's armor piercing, so the cover doesn't matter.
It's armor piercing. Well, look at that. You hit her, and you shoot her square in the head, and she falls over dead, bleeding on the ground at Cham's feet.
My character takes his left hand up and kind of grabs his rosary and sort of closes his eyes a bit. Takes the shotgun, flings it over his shoulder, and turns around and walks away from her corpse over to where Rai's standing. You all right?
I'm doing all right.
Can I try and treat Cam's
You
Cham's
can,
wounds?
So you can do first aid, and for every success you get on first aid, it'll heal a point of damage.
And what about the med packs that we have? Does that do anything? Because we had a med kit per person.
It's like
medical supplies. Let me go to that page.
Personal med kit.
It seems like it was a couple
of 98 dice. Personal med kit gives you a +2 modification to medical aid rolls. Okay. It can only be used once, so it'll give you 2 bonus
plus
dice.
+2. Yep. Okay. Cool. I will kind of run over to Cham and address his wounds. Holst him. Oh, baby!
He's bleeding pretty bad, but you got 3 points of damage that you healed that you administer.
All right, so I'm up.
We have 2 options, and I'm just going to explain it real quick right now. We just killed one of their crewmen, which I'm sure they would be quite upset if they knew about it. We either remove the evidence, or we just don't talk about it. And I look at your flamethrower.
What are you implying there, Captain?
Well, or we could just jettison her to space. I don't care. I'm just saying, they may not ever come in here. We have no idea what the fate of this whole mission is going to be, but...
Don't forget your secret agendas, people.
I got pellets right here in my damn chest and shoulder.
We can just say they disobeyed Captain's orders and...
We just be honest. Yeah, just tell her she shot. Okay. Tell them she shot me and you shot her back. I tried to do it the easy way, but...
Before y'all do anything, I'd like to search Reed to see what's on her.
That's fine. I need some
shells.
Maybe
there's
something useful. Yeah.
I'm stealing that shotgun. How much damage does it do? 3?
3.
How much damage does a punch and kick do? Just 1?
No idea.
I don't know.
All she has on her is her shotgun.
The shotgun has a 2 bonus.
She came right out of cryo sleep and immediately loaded her shotgun and went out with you guys. It's got D6 bullets.
That's disappointing.
What's the range on the shotgun? Medium?
Medium. Yeah,
okay, so it'll
2 bonus, 3 damage, medium range.
Okay, 3.
That's crazy.
Okay. And so my M240 incinerator has no bonus, but it has like really high fire intensity or something. Right? Is that correct?
Cam, can you give me your med kit so I can have one in case I need to heal you again?
Oh, yeah, I don't imagine I could use this damn thing on myself too well anyway. Here, take it. We find another one, just put it here in my little side pouch. That's where I like to keep them.
Well, let's hurry and do our objective, right?
Yes.
Yeah, let's get these... Man, can we just... Hold on a second. My shoulder is really just killing me. I'm just gonna, like, take it and, like, do, like... It's a really extensive stretch for about 10-15 seconds.
Understand that there's... Alien creatures on this ship, Jim?
Yeah, do you understand? I just got shot with a shotgun in the arm.
I do, and I healed you up. You are looking fine. I'm sure you have some residual pain, but we need to hurry.
Alright,
time to suit up and head outside.
You just want me to go and set corpses on fire and go outside for a spacewalk, all this other crap. I guess that's what my job is.
What is your other option? Would you like to die, Jim?
No, I'm not interested in that.
Okay, then. All right, so let's head to... Where are we?
Let's go back to the big map.
We need to head to an airlock, yeah.
Oh, we're in the med kit.
You're in the med bay. Med lab down there.
Freaking Reed.
And you got to get back to the stairwell, go up a level if you want to get on the... Back to the umbilical cord thing that you guys came through on. It would also take you out into space, and you can go walk out there and start to try to repair things on the ship. Spacewalking.
That's what we get for thinking we can bring in like an NPC with us to help fight monsters.
No. Okay, we've picked up a couple of different samples now. Do we have any idea? Yeah.
Shotgun.
Is that no? I mean, is that well? That's probably good for now. All right.
All right, fine.
He's following along.
Does everyone have their suit on?
Yeah, let me put my suit on with the helmet and all that.
All right, we are burning these eggs before we leave. They are.
Now that I can agree to. I just ain't setting no corpses on fire of some poor lady that just went a little nuts.
That's fine. It was just hypothetical. Now, do you think we should go check on the bridge and see what they're doing?
I think that might be a good idea. There before was a little power there, right?
Yeah. See if they're alive.
We haven't headed out yet, right?
Pardon me?
We haven't left that room yet, right?
No, you're still in the med lab, kind of discussing now your next steps.
Okay. I would like to take a spare syringe with me then.
1, 2, 3, 4.
There are no more med kits in here.
I think there's one left. I have a spare on me as well.
I think I grabbed one. I think I wrote it down. Med kit.
I'm just
med kit? Is that what you're talking about?
Oh. Yeah.
No, I'm talking about Jen the gooey black syringes.
I think there was only 4 med kits.
Okay.
And we used
she wants a syringe. Syringes. I want a med kit.
Yeah. And I have one extra syringe, and now Lauren has an extra one.
Sorry for the confusion.
So we will suit up, head out, and we are going to flamethrower the eggs that were over here and then head towards the bridge.
Yes. Okay.
Make your way in that area, and yeah, you just light up the area. There's no
anything really on our fire scanner.
You do have a motion scanner. I don't know. Are people using that thing?
Rye's been using it.
I didn't put my gun away.
She hasn't mentioned she's using it. So
you can give it to me. I'll use it. I don't care.
I'm gonna load my gun first, but I'll get it out. Let the beep boop, whatever scanning it's doing. Hopefully the batteries are dead on it.
I had a better get up front now that Reed's done. Put that scanner up front.
Yeah. Go walk up front.
Flamethrower person, right?
Sure.
I have a question. My knowledge of heavy machinery, do I know if it's like just standard that there's power on the deck during like, you know, low power mode?
Usually there's backup power because it's going to keep navigating through space as they sleep. Yeah, low power.
Just make sure. I don't know if that was some weird anomaly. I mean, honestly, if that's just standard, we should maybe try and go get comms set up first, and then maybe we can just calm them and ask them what's going on the bridge.
Guys. Comms is outside, though, right?
Yeah, you got to get the comms array going on the outside.
Let's just go do that first.
All right.
I mean, that's just my.
You don't want to go talk to them in the bridge. You're like, let's.
I am gonna go talk to them.
You're the captain, so
you guys want to split up? What's going on?
That's what I was gonna suggest. We could split up.
Yeah, let's do that. For once. And then there's this one time. We'll try it out.
Are you telling me that you're proposing that me and Wilson go together?
Yeah, you guys.
Well, I can go with Jam and Rye if you want. Don't matter to me.
Oh, you would. Oh,
Sydney by himself. Well, out I don't in space. Know.
Yeah, yeah. Send the company.
No. Not out in space. Safely in the airlock.
Oh, okay.
Protect their back.
Yeah, I don't know about all that now. But we need to.
What the hell does that mean?
Listen. What if the captain goes there and ain't got no backup? Captain. She might need some backups. All I'm saying.
If you two want to go out there, that's fine with me. I'll go with Captain Miller. I'm good with that.
Do we need both of the roughnecks together?
That is what I was going to propose. This? What if I take Rye?
You can give each other assist dice.
Okay, I'll take Rye and Wilson will go with Jam.
Wonderful.
So Wilson,
let's go, Jam.
You're not going on space, though. Let's get this correct. You're sitting.
No.
You're sitting. Okay. No. Okay.
Yeah.
I'll watch from the window. I'll be ready to open up the airlock.
Is that okay? Yeah. Rye, do you want? Unless you want to, do you want to go out in space, or do you want to go to the bridge?
I don't want
to
go in space unless I'm getting paid more. I don't see anything lucrative so far.
My character will do anything for the crew for the most part, so I just volunteered to do the thing that
is
no
Cham.
One wants to do.
I play Cham, so I know Cham well.
All right, Rye, me and you to the bridge. The other two, we will meet you as soon as we find out anything.
All
Hey, Rye, how about that scanner? You probably won't be needing it for a little bit right now.
No, I think we should keep it.
I think it'd be a good idea so we could sweep out of the way, because, you know, that thing's in the vents
exactly.
In that direction.
You know,
we'll find another one.
She's got you there.
You're a company man. You've got that fancy car. You can get somewhere. In a pinch.
He just goes off in a huff. Mumbles under his breath something about, you know, screw those damn union workers.
All right, so me and Rye are heading to the bridge, and those two are going to go upstairs.
I mean, what could go wrong? You'll be fine.
Absolutely nothing.
Yeah, so Rye and Miller, you guys head to the bridge. We'll cut between the two of you. You guys get to the bridge, cool. And the three of them are on the bridge, the three remaining crew members. The bridge is on battery reserve. So everything is shut down on here. Only faint standby illumination is given off this eerie orange glow as you enter. The blast shutters are still closed or still lowered on the cockpit and shut tight around the viewports. And there's soot on the ceiling and several of the other stations are burned out. You look over at the pilot station and you see there's an axe embedded in one of the consoles. There is no power whatsoever. You see the command station is still, it looks like it's still working for the most part. That's what's on low power, emergency power, and Mother's communicating with the captain currently when you come on board. The holographic display table is completely slagged and burnt out. It looks like someone set fire to it. And the sensor station was also damaged by the fire, it looks like, but it might be repaired. So as you enter... the captain, Johns, he turns around. He's like, what the hell happened here? Did you guys check this out? Did you do this? And he points to the axe in the pilot stations.
Why would we sabotage your ship? No, we didn't do this. We didn't even go in here. We told you that.
Well, it's going to take a hell of a lot of work to get this thing going again. Hey, where are the others? Where's Reed and the other two?
So, funny you ask. We sent the other two to focus on the communications because that's important, but... your friend Reed decided to disobey orders and fire her shotgun at us.
What? So, Reed fired? On what?
Cham, you can go check his body. It's full of shotgun holes.
Well, what did you do to her? Why did you get her riled up? She's a career Marine. She doesn't just fire willy-nilly.
She looked at the medical bay and started smashing it, and all of a sudden she said we're aliens.
What did you find in the medical bay?
Medkits?
Oh, okay, that's strange.
There's some pods that have scratches all over it. Oh, do you know what might have caused that? Because it wasn't us.
There was some crew members that were in the med pods when we went to cryostasis.
Well, they're not there anymore.
Yeah, Dr.
Flingos, well, we should take a look at it. What happened? What do you mean they're not there anymore?
Well, one was broken and blood was everywhere. And
what?
The other one, Reed smashed and we didn't see. There was no
body. Well, let's go. We should go check it out. We should see what's happening. Who knows what was in them?
Okay,
how did you guys do with them?
You go check it out. I need to go meet with my crew.
Oh.
Am I speaking Greek? This is a terrible idea. Don't you go check out those pods? We just did that.
And what did you do with them?
There was no one in there. What do you mean? We didn't do anything.
Did you look in the pods? Were they empty?
One was blood. Okay, this is like deja vu. One was bloody.
You didn't look in the pods. You guys didn't look in them.
I'm just reiterating. One was bloody, looked like whatever was in there blew up, and the other one, we just smashed open, and we had to run away.
He goes, oh, dear Lord, I'll go take a closer look at this. And Dr. Flynn shuffles away.
Alone? You...
What? He pulls out, he's got a sidearm. He's like, cocks it, I'll be fine.
Well, before you take off, can you ask Mother to cooperate with us while you're away?
Oh, the pilot, or the Captain Johns, he goes, what do you want for Mother? Yeah.
Well, I just kind of want to know what your logs are looking like. Make sure there's nothing else going on in this ship that we don't know about.
As far as we know, something got loose while we were in cryo. I thought we had everything on lockdown here, these damn creatures, but... looks like
there's been more than one thing, just to make that clear. It's not something, it's been multiple.
Well, what have you seen? Seems like you know more than us.
We saw the little creature that bursted out of your doctor. Wilson, which I don't know if you should really believe his words, he said he saw some giant spacesuit that was 7 feet tall that went through the vents, but I don't know if that's true. No one else saw that.
Yeah, you got anything to say about that? What are these creatures we keep seeing? Are you telling me you never saw any of those when you went in cryo?
We went on an archaeological survey. We found some strange artifacts, and this came with them, whatever the hell it is.
Well, why don't you go with the doctor then? Why are you splitting up?
Because this is my bridge. Why would I leave my bridge? I need to get things up and running, and I'm communicating with Mother right now.
You just said it's going to take forever.
Why don't you go with the doctor?
He's not my crew. I don't care.
So you guys are on the bridge. You guys can try and make some rolls to try and get things up and running again if you want.
Sure. What kind of role would that be?
The sensor station would take a comtech roll.
I will try to assist. Right.
All right. We're going to beep boop over here then, so we get these sensors up and going. Maybe they're better than ours.
Do the beep, do the boop. You know what to do. So she gets just a what, plus one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God.
So
my gun's like pointed at her.
Gain a stress, Rye. You succeed. You can also choose something off the chart to add to a bonus, but you also have to make a panic roll.
Oh, man. Can you only gain one stress for panic?
Yeah,
right?
It's one stress per panic.
Okay.
That you roll.
I'd like to see if there's any encrypted information on here.
Oh, okay. On the sensor? Sure. Okay. You rolled a 9, which is drop item.
Unexpected stuff.
You drop your scanner. You had the scanner with you, right?
Yes.
Yeah, right, she went.
And your stress level goes up by another 1. You drop an item and your stress level goes up by 1. So you're sitting there and you've got it in your hand and you're working away at this thing and it starts beeping.
The scanner or the sensor?
The sensor in the hallway behind you. And she freezes and she drops the damn thing. And then all of a sudden it stops and she brings the comtech, or she brings the sensor array online. And then all of a sudden on the screen, it powers on and you get sporadic blips here and there on the ship.
Is there any at the top where they're going?
No, there doesn't seem to be. And it's not moving in straight lines. You'll just get like a...
Right, yeah. A
here and there. Let's cut over to Cham and Wilson. So you guys are on the other level. Deck A. So you're out on the stairwell
deck
here.
A, okay.
And Cham, you want to go out onto the hull and do some spacewalking, and you want to try and do some repairs out here.
Yeah, right? Our goal is to, what were the two things we're trying to get running?
The sensor array and the engines.
Engines, yeah.
Okay, are they near each other?
No.
Or how? No, okay.
No, the sensor array is going to be like an actual like antenna sort of thing. Yeah, that is a lot of blips, right?
Okay. Well, let's get started.
So you get your suit on and right away you see the sensor array. It's not too far away. It's dead ahead. It's up near the where the bridge is. So you got your magnetic boots and you're walking through space and Wilson can communicate with you and you're out there. Your ship, the Montero, is still connected by this umbilical tube between the two ships. All of a sudden you get like a piercing headache and your arm gets really itchy where you got the shot. Go ahead and gain 1 stress.
Perfect.
I'm not going to mention anything.
And so you're sitting there and you're kind of shaking your head and you're in your spacesuit and you're just like, oh, what the hell? I got this splitting headache. But you shake it off and you start making your way towards the comm array. And when you get there, you've got your laser torch and your tools. And I need you to make me a comm tech roll to get it up and functional again.
Oh, was he good at that?
I don't know.
I have one rank in it. Okay.
Can always push it.
Can push it.
Oh! Gain 1 stress, and we're gonna roll panic. If you get those, you can't push your roll. From what I understand, when you panic, when you get a panic, you can't push. Yes, you roll 1 or more on your stress dice. This happens. You can't push your roll. Instead, roll for panic. So make me a panic roll, Cham.
Oh god.
You freeze. Come on, Cham, what's going on out there?
You freeze up, yeah, all of a sudden.
Hey.
You hear nothing, and you lose your next action point. Your stress level and the stress level of all friendlies in short range of you increase by one. So yours goes up by one. Wilson's not within short range of you.
Cam, come on, let's go.
Can we still talk to them, like my crew?
Yeah, you can talk to each other. You can talk, so you can hear Wilson over the communicator, and he's just so. Cam, you're just out there in space, like the dead of space, and you're frozen in place, and you're just like looking out into the stars.
Is everything okay?
Cam's just standing there. No, I don't think it's okay.
Cam, wake your ass up! You have a job to do.
Am I good to?
I think he's freaking out.
Am I good to move after a moment? How long?
Yeah, after a moment, after a few moments, all of a sudden you can hear the two of them, Wilson and Miller, shouting in your headset, and you shake out of it.
Sorry, I just have like a killer headache, and you know it's a killer headache, and you know it's just
all right, concentrate, real pretty. Man, you can get this.
It's just real pretty out here, man. I'm sorry. I'll get this taken care of. I'm just having a little trouble with the computers. Ain't as good with them as I am with a wrench. No, I'm just, hold on.
Alright, you can do this.
Alright, what can I do with ComTech? Roll again, or how's it?
You're tapped out on that. You're gonna have to get someone else to take a look at it.
Hey, try those engines out. Check out the engines. Maybe we can get those.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get these comms on myself.
We'll get Raya out here. She won't mind.
Yeah, she's a little better at that, I think.
We're a little busy.
Wilson's just on the phone told Raya. Oh, I'll go out here. She'll do it. She'll be good.
I'm sorry, Raya. I really meant to get out here and take care of this for you. I know how much you hate this.
Keeping his eye on the hallway too. He's looking out the window, but then he's looking down the hallway.
Do you have that motion sensor? Did you take Rye's motion? No.
No, she went.
We have it still.
Do I need to come back in to get to the engines?
No, you can make your way over to the engines. You have to walk around the outside of the hall, and you can open up a latch up there, and you can start working with your good old Wilson. That's right. That's right, Adam.
All
right. Start working with your laser torch. This is going to be a heavy machinery roll, but as you make your way over there and you start to open this thing, suddenly. You guys hear over all your comms. You hear the mother on the Montero, and she sends a direct message to the whole group of you. She says, displacement drive malfunction. Cascade failure imminent. Fission reactor overload in T-minus 10 minutes. Everybody gain one stress.
Do we know what that means?
It means your ship is about to blow up in 10 minutes time.
Fuck.
Our ship?
Your ship, the Montero.
Now, does Wilson know how to...
You can scuttle through that umbilical thing to try and get back, but all of you know, radius? You're like, what the hell? So Mother's droning on and on, telling you guys, and she's counting down by the minutes and the seconds that the fission reactor is overloading.
I go back. I run.
Sure, you're at the hatch.
I start heading over there.
Yeah, you can. You scuttle over. But yeah, I will give yourself space. One stress for this, and you're starting to panic. And the captain... on the other ship, Johns, he turns to you, Miller. He's like, what the hell is going on in your ship? I thought you guys were going to tow us out of here.
I look at... what did I do here?
So you know this is gonna culminate in a giant explosion. Yeah. And total destruction of your ship.
I'm yelling, hey, Rye, get your ass over here.
And or damage of the ship that you're on now.
So it might blow up.
Oh yeah,
ships.
And Cham's out in space right now too. He's not. In a good place.
He's freaking out. Wilson's yelling for Rye.
Pick up Rye by the arm and just drag her, and we're going upstairs towards the umbilical cord with the scanner that we got in the ground.
Good call there. Good call. Where are we going again? Why is this alarm going off?
Our ship is going to blow up, Rye. We are running. It's no time to space out.
Wilson's moving over as quick as he can.
I just say, good luck, Jam.
We're
gonna need you down here, girl, to get this.
And within moments, Rye and Miller over. Camp, do you want to try and get the engines up and running? You want to make this heavy machinery roll?
Definitely.
In the meantime? Okay. So make me your heavy machinery roll, please.
All right.
Woo! Those are a lot of successes, but you also gain another stress. And you have to roll me a panic roll.
Man, this is rough.
Yeah, but he nailed the shit out of that success wise.
You could add all kinds of things to that.
Yeah, those engines are freaking purring.
Frozen again.
You're frozen.
What's next turn?
He's sitting there. He's got the torch working, and he's fiddling away, and he's got it. And all of a sudden, the engines they power up. But he hears the group of you guys over the comm chatter, being like, "What the hell? What's going to go on? We're going to lose our ship. We're going to be out in space." Hey, and he freezes in place again.
We picked up a couple of other things, like Never Sleep, and is there anything that he can take?
Possibly.
Is Never Sleep like adrenaline or something?
He can also call on his rosary and all that to get rid of one stress.
Well,
right off
I'm
the
just
bat.
Saying, if Wilson thinks that he should take something, take some kind of drug, he's going to yell over. But I don't know.
Take some drugs. Let's go to the medical supplies
never
and take
sleep.
A look. Let's
I have
look.
Never, I have four pills.
So Never Sleep pills. They the pills. Stress level goes down by one per. Oh, plus one per stress level, plus one per dose for Never Sleep.
Also in space, can't put them in my mouth.
Yeah,
while
it's
in
a
space.
Fast-acting supplement that keeps you going well past your bedtime. Excessive use can use stroke each time you take a dose, your stress level goes up by one. Because you're supposed to sleep every 24 hours, otherwise that also gives you negative, so that's the point behind that. Do you have any Napro leave?
I do. Yeah.
I don't have any.
Napro
yeah.
leave reduces stress level to zero.
Oh, that's huge.
It's an injectable instant pain reliever for all strains, stresses, and irritations, recommended for use during any self-inflicted cesarean performed to extract an alien squid thing from your womb. Immediately reduce the patient's stress level to zero.
Oh.
Yeah, I hope it's not that serious.
Yeah, I want to come
so
back.
So whoever has that, Cham's freaking out quite a bit out there. And
Now, the engines are running, though, right?
Oh, the engines are up and running. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Say, Cham, come on, get back in here.
Yeah, I did it in half the time, and I'm also if they break again, I also don't want to have to roll again to have to come out here and fix it. I just want to come back out here and flick them back on.
Yeah. No, that's that works with all those successes. Definitely, those are some of the options on there.
And the with the engines being on, it doesn't mean their ship is like moving any faster or different than ours, right?
But they're like. That you could hear them shouting over your comm, get that fission explosion off immediately, otherwise we're breaking away because we're not getting caught in that explosion.
I was thinking, yeah.
And Mother just keeps counting down in your headsets.
Well, okay, we're clearly able to get this one running. Yeah, maybe we just ditch our ship and
let's go back
get out of here.
Wait, isn't this Czech heavy machinery? Why the fuck are we being bringing rye?
No, it's inside.
It's Comtech.
Yeah,
yeah,
is
it's
it Comtech?
Yes, so...
Oh. Yeah, that's why.
So Mother just keeps counting down. So you can make a Comtech roll on the reactor control.
I will assist Rai.
Rai, you get an extra die. So modifier, just put one in there.
There's no pressure, Rai, but if you fuck up, we all die. It's
and
no pressure.
Mother just keeps continuously counting down. Are you gonna try and talk to Mother or?
Mother, we're here. Just stop. Just let me know when it's like 1 minute, like a
Mother
minute intervals.
Mother refuses. Oh my god! Do you want to push that?
Off.
Do you want to?
Yes. She can't push it. She got a panic.
She can't
right?
push it because it's a panic.
Oh yeah. So gain a stress and go. Your stress goes up by one. Ryan, go ahead and make me a panic roll.
Oh, fuck. Oh. Take
You're not
damn
getting
drugs.
Oh
Son
my god!
Of a bitch,
flee.
13.
You can't take any more. You must flee to a safe place and refuse. To leave, it. You don't attack anyone and won't attempt anything dangerous. You are not allowed to make a retreat roll. So all of a sudden, Rai's like, "What the hell? I'm getting out of here!" And she scuttles out through the airlock and back through the umbilical tube to the other ship. She's like, "We're all gonna die, and I'm not gonna blow up on the Montero with the rest of you." And she just takes off.
And she
but
wants
in a more
to get
southern
paid.
Fashion.
Rai, your stress level decreases by one. But every friendly who sees you panic must make or sees you run must make an immediate panic roll. So Wilson what's our captain's name? Miller. You both need to make me a panic roll. I'm going to say Cham is in the tube as she runs by. So he's not there when she starts freaking out.
Buddy. I'm at 8. Panic already.
This is where it starts to get interesting.
Interesting is the word, yes, that you could use.
So,
God damn it,
Captain Miller, you. I love the players. This is how it's supposed to feel. You guys are feeling like, oh, no shit.
Yeah,
shit,
it's brutal.
This is bad.
It's supposed to feel like this.
So you freeze, Captain Miller. Oh, both of you freeze. And your stress level and the stress level of every PC in short distance increases by one.
So we both take one more?
Yeah,
too much of a catalyst there. That's too brutal.
This is what I get for being next to Wilson.
Yeah, Steven was, and then Cham just kind of rolls up and's like, they're both standing there frozen, standing over top of the reactor, and you're like, what's going on, guys?
Y'all, calm down. We gotta act fast. We can't just be standing here.
I understand, and I will shoot myself with my neoprene as agreed.
That's what I do also. Yeah.
So I just roll a d6, and if I get a 1, it dies? It disappears?
It just disappears, the way I read it. Disappears. It just goes, you just drop to 0 for your stress.
No, okay. for the ration of it, it's a d6 worth.
It's one dose.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so alright, we'll take it off our gear then. I'm using it, so I'm taking it off.
Naturally. Okay.
You walk in and they both start shooting up. When you're like, hey, what's going on? They turn to you and they got these dead looks in their eyes. And they both pull out their neoprene and they shoot themselves up. And all of a sudden, it looks like a weight has been taken off their shoulders.
Wilson's gonna card in and see if he can convince Mother
so Wilson,
do anything.
Well, you've got that ace up your sleeve, right? Mother
yeah.
says,
I'm hoping so.
Mother says, access denied. And
whoa,
you're
I'll
like,
try again.
You look into it, and she's like, she just refuses. It specifically says, if she's ordered by you, Wilson, and your card, she refuses. And you look over it, and you're like, there is no way to stop this. And it looks like this has been triggered. It looks like Mother triggered this herself.
Hey, Miller, can you do anything?
Can I try to use my pull rank on Mother?
You can try, but I'll tell you to save the roll. Like, Wilson, with what he's done and using his card and all that and his special access, he's learned that there's no stopping. Mother has initiated this, and there's no stopping her.
All right, I'm going to just say, let's go. And Wilson starts running.
Wilson, you know that she's following Special Order 966, which is to ensure that the Cronus is to be brought back to Weyland-Yutani in one piece. So she is effectively sacrificing herself so that you guys can't get away. And you have to use that ship to get out.
So, okay. But we need to get the Montero away from Cronus, right?
Or the Cronus away from Montero, because this is going to be a huge explosion.
Okay, well, we got engines. Okay, Wilson says, let's go. It's over.
Cham, help me one last ditch
effort. Grabs people.
This keeps counting down. You guys are at like the 5-minute mark.
What you need me to do, Cap?
I'm gonna get right in Captain Miller's face and say, hey, there's not a goddamn thing you can do. We need to get the fuck off this ship now.
If I get off this ship, we are fucking taking that ship and it is going to be mine. That is the only way I get off this ship. And if you don't
you get us all there alive, that's your fucking ship. Let's go.
Would I believe him when he says something like that? Because he's a liaison.
You can make a roll to see if you believe him. You can test it.
Wilson's look is as serious as he can look under the
situation.
No, I'm
saying, does he have that power? I guess is my question. Yeah, what do you have? Is he someone who could do that, or him just talking?
That's him just talking. Hey, Duff, how's it going? Thanks for dropping by. Oak is in the chat, and he's like, "Hey, when I played this, I was Wilson, and I manually activated this."
Oh, jeez.
He did. He went over to the ship to make sure that the Cronus didn't get away.
So he's just saying it. He doesn't have any true weight.
Well, Wilson's
it.
Like, yeah, Wilson's like, get the hell out of here.
Yeah.
He spews the order and the order number, and you know exactly what that means as well.
And the only way to override it is to do the comm.
There's no overriding this, and this is like built into Mother. This is like company policy.
But we were doing the comm tech to like turn it off.
You were doing the comm tech to see if you could turn it off. That's what that role was meant to do. Was this like to see if you could take control of the reactor to turn it off? And Wilson went in there with he's got a special key card and special access and stuff like that to Mother that you don't have. And that's where he learned this stuff. And he's like, he's laying
I
on the line.
Now.
He's laying it all out to you like, oh, there's no stopping this. This is company policy.
Part.
And you're not stopping Mother.
All right, then I will
I'll let the two of them leave first, and then I will take a second and talk to Mother and just say, can she still fly her ship, right? Like, she can still kind of move it without Mother? Anybody?
Yeah. You could ask her to. She can't really pilot or move it, no.
But she can, like, make it just go drift away, right?
Sure, yeah.
That doesn't sound confident at all.
No.
Can I go plot in? Can I go pilot and plot in, like, a course to, like...
Yeah, you can go near? To the bridge, okay. And try and plot something. Yeah, use your piloting role to try and get her... plot this thing away as fast as possible before the umbilical tube breaks.
How much time is left on the countdown?
3 minutes left.
Hear.
All right. I'm going to roll for piloting. Say,
yeah.
Oak, who played Wilson when we played it, he's in the chat. He says, "Hey, as soon as we got to the Kronos, I removed the umbilical tube." Like,
well, that might need to happen. Yeah.
Cam is just kind of silently praying to himself during this whole situation, like just freaking out.
I was gonna ask.
I think he has the highest stress.
I was gonna ask what happened to all those yellow dice, but you guys took those drugs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you get up there and you start plotting a course.
Any extra drugs?
To get away as far as away from the Kronos as possible before this thing goes off in the next 2.5 minutes.
Yeah, not
so it's now plotted in there, and you hear that the captain Johnson is like, "Get the hell off of there! That thing is gonna blow! What the hell? We need to get away from it now."
That's what I just sent it away.
All the others have made their way through the umbilical tube.
Yeah, I'm running towards the tube now.
I was hoping it was panicking in the right direction.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so you guys make your way over. Where do you go once you're somewhere over here? Safe. There's like 2 minutes left. A minute and a half by the time Miller gets over.
Where do we go?
Don't get him, Johns. Let's go. Move. Can we move the ship out?
I'm going to try and run to the
other bridge?
The bridge and see if I can get to the piloting and try
and help. So you've got the engines running now. So you guys can make a piloting roll. It's going to be a -2 piloting roll to try and get further away.
Someone want to help me?
Anybody want to assist Miller?
I am not good at piloting.
Well, you don't have to. Just give me a +1 die. So it's just
all right.
To try and negate some of that.
Have one.
Well, thanks, man.
All right, Miller, get on there. Remember, the one next to you has an axe in it. You're down the
I'm going for the one that actually works.
You get on there.
Oh.
He starts powering up. Plots in the coordinates. Banks a hard left. Starts to pull away, and as you do so, the timer counts down. All of a sudden, in space, this giant reaction goes off, and you're just blinded by the light of this explosion as the ship blows up close to you. You guys got far enough away that you did not damage the Kronos.
Phew.
The captain of the Kronos, John Strids, he's like, "What the hell is going on here?"
Taking Kronos back, obviously.
You could have damaged our ship. This is our only way out of here now. We're stuck on here with these damn things.
Oh, yeah. That's exactly how we feel too, buddy.
So and
we're
you know
on the
what?
Same damn boat.
When we make it out alive, this will become my ship because now my ship's gone and I need a new ship.
Yeah.
Some damn protocol put us here, all right? And ain't a person on board had anything to do with it, so...
You know, Mother did special code 966 and thought we should not blow up the Kronos because it was more important than the Montero, and here we are.
Yeah. Rye and Miller particularly hits the two of you that you guys lost a lot of money on that ship.
Oh, I'm aware. I'm going to have this new
that
ship.
That Helium 3 shipment was worth a lot of money.
Well, I'm assuming I'm too busy panicking to think about that.
You've stopped panicking. You've come down. Oh. You guys are all on the bridge together, and you've come down from your panic.
Did the doctor return?
Yeah, the doctor's on the bridge when you guys come back. And did you burn the body of
No, we didn't.
Reed?
How can I go about invoking the Lord Jesus Christ again to go ahead and get my
You can
stress
only do
down.
It once per act.
Since we lost a lot of money just now, I'd like to get out my worn picture of my brother.
Yeah.
And caress it. And
we did it this act already?
I let you use it when you fought the thing.
I thought that was act one.
I used it earlier. You did the rosary.
You fought
and
Reed, I said you could. Yeah, you said you pulled out your rosary.
Oh, you're talking about this session?
Yep. You pulled out your rosary when we were fighting Reed.
Oh, I never actually reduced the amount. What is it? How does that work?
You just take it down by one. Rai, okay, you start cool. thumbing well, then... the picture of your brother, and you start thinking about him and better times, and your stress level goes down by one as you think back to happier times. You get lost in thought, and suddenly the door opens to the bridge, and the doctor comes on board. He's like, "Reed is dead. What the hell happened in the med bay?" And you snap out of it, and you turn around to see him.
I point to Cam. That is what happened. Pull Reed my shot sleeve up. Her shotgun at my crew member.
Yep, and I tried to take her gun from her. First thing first, we all went in non-lethal as possible. And then she pumped a damn buckshot in my arm. So, and even then, I personally tried to yet again do this non-lethally. I got the shotgun from her, and well, yeah, it was a little too late. Why during the tussle? One of my friends put a bullet in her head. It's just how it went down. It's unfortunate. Yeah.
Wilson's going to get up on the doctor's face and say, Reed turned on us, so we took her out. Just remember that.
Is that a threat?
Fall in line, Doc.
Yes, it is a threat. This is our ship. Clearly your crew is too unstable to take care of it.
Did you want to follow our orders? Did you take the antidote? That's the most important thing right now.
Yeah, we all juiced up. We're all taking the antidote. I do have a question though, Doc. I was out there doing that little spacewalk trying to get your engines running, which I successfully did with flying colors, might I add. And
my comrade doesn't seem to be working.
Whatever. I tried doing that one too, but I ain't too good with computers. We gotta get somebody else out there again. But listen, the point I'm making is when I was out there, I started feeling real weird. My arms started feeling itchy where I got that shot at. So, is there any side effects to
that? Yeah, that's normal. Headache, itchy. Yeah, that's normal for the shots.
Okay. All right. Just making sure.
The rest of you, are you feeling any symptoms?
Apparently no.
Headache usually followed by something coming out of it. I just want to cover
headache,
my face.
Itchiness, a little lethargic for the next 24 hours. But the rest of us, we don't have things jumping out of us.
Yeah, not yet.
So I'm going to ask you this one time and one time only. To everyone on this crew, are you going to obey my orders or not? Because if you haven't noticed... We are the ones with all the guns.
Do you want to use a command roll? They have guns as well. Do you want to try and command these guys?
Yeah.
Trying to commandeer this ship?
Pretty much. I'm trying to say they're not fit because of clearly how they have done what they have done versus what we have done. They are unfit.
Is it possible to assist with the command roll by like stepping up with my flamethrower and kind of just like just adjusting and kind of staring at him?
He's trying to pull rank, right? Or she's trying to pull rank.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, my bad.
You're using
Sorry.
Your talent?
Pretty much.
I didn't know if I could assist with that. Anyway,
basically try to sway them to my side versus
your stress level goes up every time you do that. Interesting.
It does, but luckily I have zero until I roll.
I'll tell you what, the captain also has the pull rank, so you guys are gonna do dueling.
We're gonna
pull
duel
ranks. He's got a lot of stress though, so he's got more dice he's rolling.
Can I hear his argument, please?
He says, "This is my damn ship. We don't know anything about you. We're all armed as well, and we're gonna go put you, we'll lock you in the cargo bay because we don't trust you."
I just want to remind you there are only three of you and four of us. Okay, let's roll. So just roll straight command, right?
Oh my god. Yep, he got one success and he's gonna panic. 14! Is he gonna die of a heart attack?
Yeah.
In the middle of like arguing with you?
Psychotic. Attack nearest person. That son of a bitch.
So
here we are again.
He's arguing with you.
You gonna attack me,
Miller? And he's like, "Listen to me. This is my ship. This is my ship. Damn it!" And he pulls out his sidearm and he just points it at you. And he's gonna fire on you.
Oh fuck!
You attack the nearest person or creature friendly or not. You won't stop until the target is broken. Every friendly character who witnesses your rampage must make an immediate panic roll, so his crew needs to make it also. You guys
right,
are
not us,
friendly.
Right?
You guys are technically friendly.
Hell no, we're not. Not no since way. Reed. No, Reed put a... I'm not. They might be. I don't know. I've been shot by one of
Wilson
them.
Wilson doesn't
oh
have friends.
Oh my god. That's a lot of hits, Will.
I'm fucking dead.
What the shit is that?
Do you have any armor? She's got to roll. No. Another, he's got to roll another panic. 14. He said, "Cut."
That's the same thing.
Stress goes up by one.
Wait, what about the? Don't we have the story points? Don't we have like those fate points or whatever? The ones that we can use.
Wrong
like,
game.
No, we have something.
No, there's story points.
No, I used it. I used it for the piloting or something.
Oh yeah, that is right.
Story points. You don't want to die. That's what this is.
Well, this is kind of like a OMG.
What, the psychotic?
I'm just getting shot at and I insta die.
Hold on. Personal agendas? Is that what you're... Let's see here. I'm going through the...
No, you told us in the beginning that each session we have like these...
Story points. Yeah, we have two.
That we can
I
use.
I just found it on my character sheet.
Right. Story points.
Story points, gain one,
max three by playing your agenda. Spend to add 1d6 to a roll.
Yeah, they don't do much then. Not to help
1d6.
So she he unloads his pistol point blank on you. Do you have any armor?
Can I do dodge like in whatchamacallit? Forbidden Lands?
Let's see. I don't remember. It's a great question.
I don't think there is one.
Well, there's like block attack. I mean, we're in close combat. if not, it's okay. I'm just trying to see if
there's any
reaction. Because obviously I cannot.
All right, let's go to the book here and see if you
survive.
Can...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's a lot.
Can I jump in the way of the bullet as a reaction?
I don't,
Wilson, throw
no,
someone
does
in front of me.
Have a power to help your captain out?
I don't think that mine does that.
If it was Wilson being shot, he could have someone else get in the way.
Oh,
of
I'd
it.
Be good. Yeah, but I can't do it for someone else.
Man,
I would willingly do it if I.
All right. Yeah,
let me double check here.
Now, do I get injured or something?
Crazy. People going psychotic.
If you die, there are other NPCs, at least.
There are other NPCs to play as. Don't you worry.
But I won the roll. I just made it. I made it a ship.
And then you got shot like a motherfucking dog.
Because the captain went psychotic.
I literally said they're unfit, and then he shot me.
I know.
And that's some cinematic shit, right?
It's
not a movie. I feel like that'd be
the
perfect way to
roll.
Go out.
He pulls a gun and just unloads on you and goes psychotic.
Jeez, man.
All right, page 53. Here we go.
I mean, I'm definitely down, so I mean.
Well, I mean, I know for me, you know, Wilson, I mean, I'm assuming we're going to react here.
Oh, yeah, you're going to react.
Yeah, okay.
100% I mean, you're going to react.
Yeah.
If I could jump in the way, I could, I would, but I don't have the talent or anything that lets me do that.
Close combat. I'm just looking at blocking. If you're attacked in close combat, you can choose to block the attack to avoid being hit. Blocking is a fast action. And you roll your close combat.
I'm just trying to see if there is any reaction, that's all.
Ooh. You can try to disarm. Reactive action. Blocking is a reactive action that breaks the normal initiative. Well, that's what you're trying to do.
Block a bullet.
Blocking unarmed. If you're unarmed, you can only block unarmed attacks from other humans to block an armed attack. Grappling, pushing, retreat. It doesn't really look like there's a way to avoid being shot.
So we're not technically in initiative combat.
No, this was a surprise because he went psychotic. You're going to be in initiative now because Buddy just went like crazy on you and unloaded.
Now am I dead or do I roll critical injury? That's all
yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, okay. You're gonna roll in the critical injury table. Miller just drops in front of you and is bleeding on the floor.
I'd like to do recovery for a person who's dropped to zero is broken. If you apply medical aid skills and you roll success, they get on their feet and immediately recover a number of health points equal to the die.
What does that do? Whoa, what?
I'm just trying to heal.
Medical aid. I'm trying to do recovery.
Okay, well let's roll the critical injury here. And see what happens to old Captain Miller.
If it's high, it's bad. If
it
it's
could be
low,
permanent death. Critical injury. So normally a D66. 46.
Ruptured intestines.
Fuck.
Yes, ruptured intestines. It is a fatal wound. You will time limit is one shift, so that's and disease with virulence 6. Healing time is 2d6. Ooh, so you need to make a virulence check, don't you?
So she shot me right in the stomach.
Right in the gut, and all of a sudden, like, your stomach acid just starts eating away at your intestines.
So I need to make a check?
Yeah. Where are the rules for virulence now?
Jeez, shit hit the fan.
It hit fast and hard, too, man.
Well, good news is I made the roll, so hopefully maybe they'll help you. I don't know.
I'm about to kill this guy, though.
Well, I was on my way to slowly trying to talk to each of you to, like, commandeer the ship. Well, except Wilson. The two of you.
We're all there, right?
When this happens. Oh, yeah. You're all standing there. Okay. You just witnessed Buddy pull a gun, go psychotic, and shoot your captain point blank as she drops to the ground.
Yep.
All right. Well, I can't... Oh, there we go. Disease. When exposed to deranges,
I have a med kit and surgical kit on my body. Just
so a typical disease is a virulence of 3, but there are diseases much higher. If you fail your roll, you fall sick. So make me a stamina roll, please.
Stamina.
And it's against a virulence of 6.
I have to get 6 successes?
Yeah. Otherwise...
Well, it's not possible.
One shift after infection, the disease breaks out, at which time you suffer 1 point of damage. You can't recover your health while sick. Make another sickness roll at the start of each shift. Each failed roll means you suffer another point of damage. If you're broken while sick, you must make another sickness roll after every shift. Failure means death. As soon as you succeed a sickness roll, you are no longer sick. So people can aid you. This is for medical aid. Someone can, like, quickly dive down and administer medical aid to you.
All right, well, I am sick.
Okay. Well, this just got interesting. Fast. So your captain just dropped. John's is standing with a gun. The others are not... jumping in and participating. They're kind of taken aback by what just happened. And they are surprised by what just took place. The doctor's like, my god, you're gonna kill him! And,
blah!
And the company man or woman is also just like, what is going on? So let's go ahead and add you all turn orders, and you can try and stop this psychotic captain who has a gun out and shooting your captain. So let's deal cards to everyone. And let's... I did not expect to have combat here, so there's a card for everyone.
You must still be in initiative?
Yeah, because you're going to have to roll, case. Otherwise you're going to die.
Okay, great. Oops, okay. At the end.
Okay, great. That's it for old
Captain Good old Miller.
All right, Rye, what did you get? 2. Nice.
Ooh, good.
All right, so you're standing there on the deck. Miller's dropped to the ground. John's is standing there with a gun in his hand. Rye, you're up first. What do you want to do?
My plan was to try to heal our fallen captain. You know, keep your enemies closer.
Yeah, you can. That's, like, you can do that. She's right at your feet, so you can just dive down. You don't need to move up a range band.
And so at this point, would it be recovery or would it be save a life?
Where are you looking? What page number? I'm sorry.
I'm just looking at what medical aid does.
It should just be first aid on us as a slow action. Yeah, broken or dying victim.
It's going to be first aid, and you can, if you're using one of your med kits, you get a +2.
Perfect.
Wow. That was unexpected. The dice! Unexpected. Psychotic. Alright, so you heal 2 points of damage to your captain, but you also now need to panic. Gain a stress and panic. 9. I think that's good. I think that's low.
Yeah.
So you take 1 stress, and 9 means drop item. Stress, confusion, realization, You drop weapon or other important item. The GM decides what, and your stress level increases by one. You used your med kit. What else were you holding?
The scanner still.
All right, your scanner drops again. It beeps. Bloop. Behind you, and you drop it. You drop it.
Here they come.
Every time I drop it, it beeps. That's what I'm saying. It's broken.
All right, so that's Rye's turn. Unless she wants to move. Are you going to stay at the captain's?
I'll stay here as a pseudo meat shield, I guess.
You're all on the bridge here, standing at the door of the bridge, so, and John's is right in front of you.
So did that heal, or did that just stabilize?
Healed, and he's up to, she's up to 2 hit points now, so she's like,
okay. Gasped. All right, so she's not gonna
eyes
die.
Eyes open up.
Right.
For okay. now.
Yeah. All right. Well, I was just figuring, we gotta have at least one captain, so... Wilson was just, you know, taking a look.
So, Cam, you're up.
Okay. My immediate thought was to kill this guy, but then my next thought is tactically, I think the disarming thing is actually really good because you can't shoot anybody else.
He's going crazy, too. He's just rambling and spewing things off. So, remember, he's psychotic, and it doesn't end. You won't stop until you or the target is broken. I guess it stopped because he dropped Miller, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, so yeah. So he's sitting there. He's got the gun in his hand.
I still want to try and disarm him.
Sure. Go for it.
All right.
Gain a stress and roll me a panic, but you successfully did.
Okay, sorry. Panic.
Oh my god, he's going psychotic again. No! No! You disarm him. Successfully disarm him, but he starts throwing punches at you.
At least he doesn't have a gun.
Attack the nearest enemy, so he's just going to do a close combat attack on you.
I'm going to block it.
This is Reed all over.
He hits you.
Can I block? How do I block
it? Yeah, you can attempt to block it. Wow, he rolled a 16. Is he going to die of a heart attack now? Oh my, okay, so he swings at you, you block it, and he falls to the floor, catatonic, staring blankly. He's just staring blankly at the ceiling, catatonic.
Do I take another stress because all those pain?
Yes, nice. Take another stress, but he collapses to the floor after swinging at you, and you blocking it. is good, I love it, the dice are telling the tale.
Yeah. That just saved that motherfucker's life because Wilson was going next.
All right, combat.
Anybody got any binds?
Oh, he was lucky as shit.
Is he dead? Like he has a heart attack? Like dead? Or is he just like unconscious?
He's just unconscious.
Oh.
Lynn and Clayton, who are there, and they're just like, "What is going on? What just came over the captain? We're sorry."
I don't know. That's your damn second crew member to freaking go nuts. First one shot me with a shotgun. Second one done put our captain on the floor. Busted her guts out.
Doctor, do you know how to... I don't feel well. Not like... I feel like ill. Like, is there any way to... I don't... besides my stomach, I feel bad.
Does anybody have any binds or
and
anything?
And I will kind of like slowly crawl on the floor because I'm not...
Yeah, you're crawling toward Flynn.
And I'll pull out my pistol and I'm blowing the head of the captain.
What? Really?
Yes. Yes, he fucking shot me to death.
You all gain a stress.
I'm at 10 stress now. Thanks, pal.
Nuts. You think your captain's nuts? That guy's defenseless on the ground. He just pulls out his gun, she pulls her gun and bang in the head. Everybody gain a stress.
Care. I was just going to tie him up or something in a chair. But
what do I do now that I'm at 10 stress?
I think it's just when you roll panic.
You need to chill out. Ask Flynn. Then we need some
What am I rolling here?
Pyro's thing.
I'm at 10 stress. What do I do?
I don't think anything until you roll panic.
No, you're just at your max.
Oh, it just affects how bad my panic roll is. Got it.
You're asking the medic to try and heal you?
Well, no, I'm like asking this, Flynn, after we need that
after you blow the head off the captain.
I already convinced them before I got shot.
You get two more hit points back, but now they're going to panic.
Oh my god. What, it's like, a 12? Why even roll?
What does a 12 mean? They start screaming. They see you blow the head off their captain. He just, every friendly character must make an immediate panic roll. Everybody make me a panic roll.
Everyone?
Well, you're friendly to the doctor.
Shit.
Rye, you're seeking cover. You're jumping behind machinery. Oh my god, who's going psychotic? Cam? Sam, Cam's going psychotic. Nothing happens to Miller, and nothing happens with Wilson.
Wilson's calm and cool.
So, Cam, you immediately attack the nearest person or creature, friendly or not. You will not stop unless your target is broken. Every friendly character witnesses this must make an immediate panic roll.
Can I...
wait to panic again?
Yes, because you're... Cam is now pulling a shotgun. And he's now going to unload it on someone.
Well, I'm going to pull rank whenever.
Oh, yeah. Okay, well... Everybody make me another panic roll.
Okay.
You're good. I gain a stress. Do we gain a stress?
No, it doesn't gain a stress.
This is my second one. I'm good.
So, Rye, you're frozen as you watch Cam. So, Miller moved up here. Closest would be, I guess, Flynn, the doctor? So, make me a ranged attack roll against Flynn.
Can I pull rank on him?
Yeah, you can pull rank. Mm-hmm. Hey, Rye, while you're lying there taking cover... You notice that your scanner is starting to go off, and it looks like there's movement coming down the hallway towards the bridge.
And all this screaming's just setting this beeping thing off again. Now things are coming in.
I'm gonna push my roll, so I just do minus one.
Yeah.
Right.
There's something coming down the hallway towards you guys.
So three successes, and you make a manipulation test, Cam.
Can't make me a manipulation test to try and resist the captain who's trying to talk you down. Kevin's lying on the floor. The bloody mess.
Stop it, Cam!
Yeah.
Oh, we tie. What happens when we tie?
It'll go to you.
The hell's okay, all that
so
he shit.
Stops and when he can- Cam, did you roll to hit? Flynn, you still get a shot off.
Oh, my bad. My bad.
So shoot Flynn the doctor.
I just didn't want to.
Oh, you're crazy. You're psychotic.
I know.
Three damage. Oh my
Gee,
god.
He's four dead. Damage oh, and four oh. stress? Or what?
Yeah. So you unload on Flynn. Bloody mess. He flies backwards onto the controls of the ship. I need to roll a D66 for a critical injury.
Y'all done shooting me up. Keep shooting me up. This is what I gotta do, huh? This is what I gotta do.
You stop panicking because, like,
45. So you got a bleeding gut. So 1 point of damage at every roll for mobility and close combat. So he's lying there. He's unconscious and his gut.
I didn't mean
out.
To.
You shot him right in the gut with your shotgun.
I was just trying to shoot him in the foot. I was trying to get him off of me.
Everyone,
like, God, stop
moving.
Stop.
Everyone, drop their guns. Stop moving. Drop your guns. No more. I will go with my first aid to try and heal the freaking doctor so he's not dead.
You pull yourself over in a pool of blood and you start trying to administer first blade aid on the doctor.
Yes.
Can I assist?
Yes, you can
or
assist.
Am I still
yes.
freaking out?
No, you're good now.
Okay.
Oh, skein of stress there, Captain, and a whole lot of panic. You're good. You're fine.
Right,
you gained the stress, though? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. One, two.
Wow, Wilson things are getting a little
shotgun.
Crazy, eh?
Yeah, yeah. Is it still beeping?
Oh, yeah, it's
not
still
sure.
beeping. It's still
sure
beeping.
A beep
it's coming
right.
closer and closer.
Where's it beeping from? Like,
it's coming
direction?
From the hallway south of you. It's coming towards the
so
bridge.
So here?
Yeah. That's.
Does Clayton have a Boop. Weapon?
Boop. Does anyone need a weapon?
The doc or Clayton, do either one of them have a weapon?
The doc has a sidearm. Clayton okay. has... What does Clayton have? Clayton has a pistol as well.
Okay.
There is something coming. Everyone take cover quickly and focus at the door.
Oh, actually, no, the doctor's unarmed. It's just Clayton who has the pistol.
I can throw a pistol to the doctor.
Yeah, I'll just say... Okay, yeah.
Let's I was
make sure
say,
the doc has a pistol.
Everybody's just
Me
tossing
shield.
Pistols around, eh?
Is Clayton up? Clayton, are you all right?
I think Clayton's alive.
Clayton's fine.
Okay. Oh no, I'm sorry. Cam.
Oh yeah.
Cam's up, but a little crazy.
I'm.
Can you still use that flamethrower?
I'm afraid.
It's yes or no.
Yeah, maybe.
Doctor, do you have any of the neparine, any of the drugs?
Neparine? He goes, oh, yes. Yeah, I've got one on me.
Give it to me.
Why?
So I can give it to Cam. He just tried to shoot you.
Yeah, give it to Cam.
What are we giving me?
Okay. I don't
even know. Okay, so I just want roll command on it.
Yeah, roll command.
Look at the door, Cam.
I'm starting to not be able to recognize y'all's faces now. This is,
There we go.
Sure, he slides it across the floor to you.
All right, I'll stick it in Cam. Get him up. So, Cam, you can remove all your stress.
Oh, my God, that's beautiful. Well, this feels nice, doesn't it?
Okay, this is what's going to happen. The four of us are going to stand by the door. Doctor and Clayton, you stay in the back, because I swear if you shoot something, I'm sure you'll hit us or you'll just freak out.
Oh, what do we need?
Listen, Miller. Why don't you agree that it's always a good idea to keep your friends close, but your enemies closer?
That's what I'm saying. They're behind us, which is close, so, and the enemies are in front.
But we got meat shields now,
the
right?
The beeping on the scanner gets right up to the door of the bridge and then stops.
Talking about putting them in, up front.
Is there any vents in this room that we can see?
Well, funny enough, you start to see it moving along the side of the room.
All right, I'll just have my gun trained where we see the beep.
What? Can y'all mind updating me on what's going on right now?
There is a fucking alien entering the bridge. Pay the fuck attention!
Finger,
and I'm pointing.
Look, what the thing you just shot me in the arm with has got me feeling.
You don't know it's an alien?
Well, I'm pretty sure someone called an alien. Reed did or something. Someone said the word alien.
It's just a blip. It could be a kid for all we know.
Focus, everyone, at the beeps.
Or a cat. Cats like vents, I know personally.
Cats cannot breathe. Cats cannot breathe when there's no air. I hate to break it to you, Rye, but there's no such thing as space cats.
Well, what if he was in a pod and he got out somehow? Now he's looking for us. Are we really going to shoot a cat?
We're going to shoot a fucking cat.
Honestly, at this point, Rye, I'm half tempted to shoot one.
I'm going to command you to shoot a cat, yes. Everything is going to
shoot anything that fucking moves that comes in here.
Yeah, that's about where I'm at, too. And I love damn cats, y'all. I'm telling you.
I'm good with them, but...
Yeah, so I'm just...
Not today.
Focusing on where the beeps are.
Sure.
And I'm telling the other two to just, like, lay prone, don't do anything.
The
like
beeps
hide.
Follow, and it ends at a vent shaft over here.
I'm going to train my the barrel of my
where'd you
flamethrower onto it.
You're right here? Is that where you went?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm like towards the middle. Like
all of a sudden, there's another blip coming up the other side.
So bitch.
Maybe the cat has a friend. You ever
and it stops.
Whoa. What? Where is it stopping?
It stops at a vent over on this end.
Everyone focus on the same vent.
No, it's on. There's two different ones.
I'll let Sham focus on the right, and we'll all focus on the left.
I'm going to go ahead and just light the vent up.
Oh, that works.
Sure, you
I'd
just
like
fire
to
on the vent.
Way.
Yeah, I'm just going to
fire
my flamethrower into the
which
vent.
Which one?
Yeah. The first vent that had activity in it.
You start unloading. You can. So all of a sudden, the movement thing starts backing away.
No. Scared against fire.
Vent bursts open, and this little alien creature pops out. It's like 6 to 7 feet. It's got like a dome, long dome head and a scaly kind of body.
6 to 7 feet is little.
And it gets a surprise attack on you guys as you're attacking the other vent.
I said I was looking at this vent.
All right, well then it's gonna jump right at you.
Surprise.
Okay, you're not surprised, but he still gets the attack.
It's got
big whoop.
These guys have like special stuff for surprising you.
How are we surprised with beepings and we're staring at the?
You guys are unloading fire on one vent.
We're scared.
That was one
it's
guy.
Alien.
Well,
of course
so
it
you guys all
over
your eyes as he's like lighting up.
We're
like,
all scared.
Oh, let's not look. Let's look the other way. Come on now. Let's be real here. So I'm rolling a D4. Oh, the captain's not a target. It's a D3. Captain's dead. Or he's lying on the floor catatonic.
Yeah.
So we got
D3.
We got the company man, Miller, and Rye are all targets. This thing bursts out. 1, 2, 3.
This company
Rye. Man, no. This thing jumps out and jumps at you.
Oh God.
And it gets a surprise attack on you.
Carrying that scanner, beeping.
Oh, that scanner's going nuts.
That's why it jumped on her.
It's so helpful.
Charles them right up to me.
It's like when you have like your reverse camera
sorry,
like on cars. You get to
all right, so let's roll an attack on you.
Let's.
We this, dead.
This could be interesting. This could be very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
We just got the ship.
Great way I can push this thing away from me, or am I just too surprised?
Just too scared.
You're surprised. This is a surprise round. You can try to push it away, I suppose. Let me roll here to try and get you.
Hmm. You can block melee attacks.
Okay, we need to be done with anything not lethal. Shoot, burn, kill.
Oh yeah, I'm over that tactic.
Okay.
Don't worry. Well, the second time I did it was because I figured disarming would be wise, because disarming is actually pretty good.
I got one success as it springs out of the vent at you.
See if you can block that. That shouldn't be hard.
You can try and block it.
With your armor.
Oh, gain a stress. You block it, and roll me a panic roll. 13.
That's my number.
Oh,
flee! You
terrible.
Can't take it anymore. You must flee to a safe place. Refuse to leave it. You won't attack anyone and won't attempt anything dangerous. You are not allowed to make a. You're not allowed to make a retreat roll if an enemy is engaged in range when you flee. Oh,
so
that means it gets an attack of opportunity on you.
She can do a counter attack though if she successfully blocks as a blocking stunt.
Yeah, you do have all those stunts. All
your stress level is decreased by one. Right. So take your stress level down by one. But other friendly characters who see you flee must make a panic immediate panic roll. So Miller,
God.
Wilson, Cam, make me a panic roll as this thing jumps out and you watch Rye turn around and start to book it from this thing.
Have any of you ever played the board game Pandora or no? So Pandemic, sorry.
It's
like this.
This is like Pandemic, man.
thank you for the follow, Cora 73. Appreciate it. Things are getting a little crazy here in Alien.
I just done nervous twitch. Everyone gets a fucking one more stress.
All right, thanks to the company man, you'll get one more stress.
Yeah, I'll get one more stress. I'm assuming I do.
Yeah. What happened with yours there, and, Wilson?
Oh yeah, your.
Oh no, that was Wilson.
That was me. Yeah,
Miller.
I twitched.
Miller,
I have tremble.
-2 to all panic stops. All right.
Okay.
So you try to immediately flee. So this thing is going to get another attack against you for free.
Of course it is.
Of course.
We are so fucked.
Early.
It has one hit. So
do you have armor, Ryan?
You take one. Oh, do you have any armor? Because it's going to. This one can't be blocked as you flee.
I have two.
So roll your armor dice.
So. Because she fleed, that's why she couldn't get a counterattack.
Yeah, she's running away in fear.
That's no good.
Okay.
So you don't block it. And the way the attacks work for the aliens is similar to the bad guys in Forbidden Lands, anybody who played my games. You roll on a random table. I don't have a set attack. I roll randomly to see what it does to you. So I don't even know. It's a D6.
Oh, okay.
So I rolled a 5. That is throat bite. The Neomorph attacks by biting the victim in the throat. Roll for attack using 8 base dice, damage a 1. If the attack causes damage, it automatically inflicts a critical injury, number 61, triggering immediate panic roll. All right.
It's been nice, Ryan.
Ruptured jugular? Oh my god.
Oh shit.
You die in one round.
So this thing leaps on Rai. All of a sudden, its little dice. Mouth juts out and hits Rai, and Rai's throat tears open, and blood starts spewing everywhere, and Rai falls to the ground. But Rai, what else happens?
You turn into an alien.
I guess it's revealed that I'm not actually a human.
Within the blood, this milky white substance starts spewing out of Rai's neck.
Jeez, what the shit?
Rai is a synth!
Wow.
And you guys didn't know this. You're all so like, what the fuck?
Does that mean she actually dies?
No. Well, no. Rai now has special abilities.
She doesn't need the throat.
She now becomes a synth. Yeah. And is now playing as a synth.
Ah, yes, the meat shield's alive.
Synths have a... Well, the synth, buddy. We're using this as the reveal for the synth. Synths do have a separate entry table, but they act as humans until reveal. Everybody's gonna make me a panic test. Yes, thank you for reminding me, Oak.
Everybody? That's the third one.
This thing is not interested in eating Rai any longer after it tastes...
Fuck, who rolled a 7? Shit. That's what I rolled last time.
I love how the stretch. You guys are just getting stressed by this.
So nervous twitch.
Your stress level and stress level of your friendlies in short range increases by one. Everybody takes a stress.
Right. My friend, what is going on with what's happening here?
Right, I think. Rai, you should have instructions in your character sheet for playing as a synth now, I believe. It was perfect that it attacked Rai, actually, because now this got to play out. I was wondering when this was going to happen, when it was going to reveal that Rai was a synth.
So are we in initiative, or what's happening now?
Yeah, we're in initiative. Let's go ahead and do that.
God.
That's my best friend.
Your best friend is not
just damn robot.
Thought it was
mortal. Yeah.
Do I need to recall all the cards? Those are from the last round, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Wow, that got crazy, huh?
Yeah, it's been crazy
this
entire time. We've rolled 35 panic rolls.
Guess what?
Nine.
God,
all right, so now you'll be rolling on the synth injury table.
Are you kidding
Rai?
Me? A one?
Jen, there is a... Does your character sheet have all the information, all that, for playing as a synth?
Unless you gave me a new character sheet, I'm not seeing anything.
I have a handout here. Here's a whole handout and book on playing as synths. I'm going to share
memorized
that with you.
Got some death claw for aliens.
Oh, it's on all players. There you go. I'll just show it to you. You can look through it.
Wow, cool.
I need a roll
d6. No, your card. What's your card number?
Oh. 7. Sorry.
So, synths don't take stress, right?
Nope.
Synths cannot take stress at all. But...
And I can't push anything.
Synths can't push. That's the trade-off. Page 75. Thanks, Adam. Do you have the PDF there handy? Janet's also got the rules for synths.
I did have some cheat sheets, but I'll have to reread a little bit.
So, as you guys are there, this thing's in front of you screaming, and you got the beeping, bloop, 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 coming down the hallway behind you.
Wait, we have more beeping?
You get +3 strength and agility, says Adam.
Holy shit.
Synths are crazy, but they can't push. Yeah, there's more beeping. So this thing now has, it's still got the 3 targets in front of it. Let's see who it attacks. Oh, it's going to attack Clayton. It hits. Clayton's going to try and defend herself. And she is unsuccessful.
Oh.
So let's roll on the table to see what this thing does to Clayton. D6 D6. Six. That can't be good.
No.
If a five was rip your throat open and like kill you, a six can't be good.
Tear your head from your body.
Oh, this is crazy. This is great. It's playing out different than last time. I love it. D6. Where is it? Okay, so a six. Tail spike. All of a sudden it levels its tail and it impales the victim with a razor sharp tail. Roll for attack using 7 base die, damage of 1. All right, so it's still got a roll to hit. It's got a roll to hit. It can miss. It hit. Damage of 1. The attack is armor piercing, having any armor rating. If the attack causes damage, it automatically triggers critical injury number 66, killing the victim outright. So all of a sudden, this tail pierces through Clayton. It lifts her up in the air, and she's holding the tail that's through the other end of her. She's screaming, and there's blood spewing everywhere. And this thing just kind of whips her to the other end of the room. And she thuds against the wall, and blood smears down, and she slumps over the other side of the bridge in a pool of blood. This is a juvenile that I'm putting you guys up against.
Yeah, I know.
This isn't even the real deal.
Oh, it's the real deal, all right. Yeah. Just not the full blown one. It's just terrifying.
All right, man.
Remember those NPCs that we were gonna play in case someone died?
Yeah, they're slowly dying. The NPCs are slowly dying. Wilson, you're up. Oh my god, you just watched this thing pierce the other company.
Take out the other company,
man. Whip her across the room, and she died instantly, bleeding everywhere.
Alright, he takes a shotgun, levels it at this damn thing's head, and takes a shot.
Yeah.
Let's see here. Hopefully I'm doing this right.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Was that when it says?
That's a hit.
Three. Yeah, but three. So what damage is that? Is that
it does three damage, but you can add an additional one for each additional success. You can do 4 damage to this thing. Do you want to?
Ranged combat. You can.
What else can you do with it? Let me ask you that.
Well, I was just gonna say. Let's see.
I'm gonna tell you, it's got some natural armor. Is there anything you can do to bypass armor?
No. I can make it prone or push it back, but that's still.
You push it back into the.
Well. No, we're at the beginning of the round. I'm doing all damage.
All 4 damage? Okay.
Yeah, all 4 damage.
I'm going to roll its armor to see if it soaks any of it up. It doesn't! Ho ho ho! All right, so you just... Wilson levels a shotgun. Bam! Unloads, and this thing explodes. It lets out a screech as it explodes. As it does so, its blood hits the hull behind it, and acid hits the metal and starts... burning, and you see smoke lifting up on the where its blood hits, and the blood acid on everyone. No, it went through it. There's a pool of blood at its feet, and its acid starts burning through the floor. The power of the company. That's right. That's right. Bam, company man. And there's just this pool of acid, and the smell of metal, acidic metal hitting your nostrils. You guys all take stock of what's just happened. You see Clayton lying over there. Rye is sitting with her throat ripped open. It's just like this milky substance just pumping, oozing out of it. You're at a loss. Like, what the hell, Rye? None of you had a clue that Rye was a synth.
Yeah.
Rye, your agendas change when you're a synth. FYI.
I've been selectively kind of playing both.
Okay. So, yeah. All right. Everybody gains a stress when a person nearby is revealed to be an android. So you all gain a stress for that.
Do we, lose a stress because we killed an alien?
No.
No, of course not. There's no positives to being badass. Only negatives to being losers.
Flynn is like,
They're alive. They're here. What is that thing? What is going on? We need to get out of here. They're on the ship.
There is no other ship to go to.
They're on our ship. We need to find safety.
Say, Doc, you're about 2 seconds away from taking the shotgun to the face. Shut the fuck up. Pull your shit together.
There is nowhere safe. Let's just be clear. There is nowhere safe. The only thing we can
do is fucking stress it.
We need to go somewhere with no vents. That's the best I could say. I will ask Mother if she knows of a location that would be best fortified for us. That is preferably on this floor. Like no vent shit, like just one door.
So you guys can see the vents. You can actually see the vents on the maps. Those little lines going around
the rooms,
those are vents. Oh, those and you guys actually vents. Have the layout of this ship. It was given to you by your mother. So you can see where the vents go on each level. You have handouts as well for each level in Roll 20.
Here, well, I'll show them all. This is one of the worst places.
Yes.
Yeah, you don't say.
Coincidence, huh?
We could go to the vestibules.
Outside, there you go. Oak says go outside.
No.
No.
They don't need to breathe.
I'd like to walk over and examine the downed creature.
Yeah, okay. You can make me a science roll?
Observation or science?
Is there still a bunch of blips going on here?
The blips have stopped. There is no science. I thought I read there was science somewhere, but there's no science. Observation. You're unable to determine anything.
Are we going to talk about the fact that you are not human? And that there's still stuff coming out of you? Are we familiar with androids at all?
You're familiar with androids. Okay. Cham, you're kind of like at a loss here, because this is your best friend. Yeah, you thought you knew everything about Rai. Remember, like, part of your thing is, like, your family, and now you're just, like, all of that is, like, thrown out the airlock.
I'm just actually kind of staying away from her. I'm a little freaked out by her at this point.
Okay,
we need to move. Like you said, Captain, agreed. We need to move.
So vestibules has no areas.
Vestibule 1 and 2.
That doesn't really give us anywhere to go.
What about all those nights we were drinking and you were out drinking me? You just let it slide, and made me feel like I didn't know what the hell I was doing. Is that how it went?
Whatever makes you feel better.
You don't even sound like the damn same person I knew.
This is creepy. Can you not talk, please? I mean, you were Rai. You're no longer Rai. What do we call you?
I said I was Lucas.
Lucas.
Yeah.
Okay. Suggestion. We go to Mother's room. There is no vents, no nothing. We run to deck A.
Okay.
Sit in Mother. There's one door in, one door out. We have food and hydration. Clint, we picked it up. I have some on my sheet. Or we can try and stop by and grab some stuff.
But can we pilot the ship from there through Mother?
Ooh, good question.
I'm thinking we can.
Is that possible with Mother?
To ask Mother to pilot it? You could try. I guess you're now, well, with the
I'm the captain.
With Miller, with John's out. You're the highest ranking captain here.
Mother, could you fly this ship if we were to stay in your quarters?
Says we could navigate the ship from here. You could navigate the ship from there. She agrees. She confirms.
I say we just run in there and barricade ourselves.
Go up a level to Mother.
What do you guys think?
I agree as far as getting the hell off the bridge.
This is the worst place, obviously. Yes. There's seven vents in here.
Yeah, we at least need to move for sure.
Alright.
Whatever you think we need to do.
There's some questions. How long is it going to take us to get anywhere? You know, I mean.
I understand.
Food and water, but right. Agreed. First thing, get the hell out of this room.
Alright, let's run to the stairwell then.
Yep.
With the doctor, I suppose.
Yes.
Camel, nod to everyone and step up and start leading the way with his flamethrower.
John's have anything worthwhile taking off of his body?
John, are you taking him? Are you taking him with you? Or are you leaving him lying here?
We're taking the doctor, but we're checking for any supplies, anything.
He's got a pistol and a key card. Yeah, he's got the key card to get into Mother. But you already have a key card to get into Mother, Wilson.
Right. So Miller, can grab that one.
Sure. I mean, I'm the captain. The Mother will let me in, but yeah, I'll grab it. But I don't think.
No. Okay. Is there any medical supplies in here? In the bridge?
I'm gonna say there's one med pack in here. Like a first aid sort of kit. So there's one med kit.
Grab. Who doesn't?
You are not Lucas. No, you are not getting in the back. You just betrayed everyone in the crew. You were going in the front near your was friend Cam. No, I don't know if you're friends anymore because you're not the same. But you are not in the back.
I can take Fran.
Perfect.
Listen,
your name's been changed to Lucas.
It's just going to run by me.
She's different and all, but she's still with us. So no need to treat her like.
I'm not treating her differently. I just don't want her in the back because who knows what might happen.
Yeah, that's true. All right.
Do we have the does Lucas still have the I'll just look. Still have the beep boop thing?
Lucas still has the beep boop
scanner.
Thing. Yeah. Scanner. Yeah. Okay, I just don't want to leave it.
Yes.
I dropped it back there.
Okay, well then I'll pick it up.
Okay, and we're heading to Mother's room.
Oh my god. It was too perfect that we rolled randomly to hit Rye and now reveal Lucas. That was great. I love it. I was wondering when that was gonna happen. You guys had a synth in your midst all along, and you thought the bad guy was Wilson. No. There's nothing wrong with synths. They're not bad guys.
We have two bad guys now.
Hey,
synths aren't bad guys. Remember,
I just fucking killed the alien. I'm the hero of the fucking show.
What's his name? Lance Henriksen from the second one. I don't remember his character's name. He was a good synth. He saved Ripley's life.
Yeah. Alright, we move out.
He did that knife trick. Bishop, thank you. Yeah, Bishop was a good synth.
Bishop was badass.
Don't let Ash taint your view of synths, right? All right.
Yeah, Bishop was awesome.
Let's gather up the posse here. We can delete you and make you go.
We leave.
You're not taking John's with you? You're leaving John's there?
John's is dead. I shot him in the head. Him.
Oh, yeah. I forgot you shot John's.
Fuck John.
I'll take his pistol.
Bishop takes a queen. A queen takes a bishop. Womp womp. Good one, Adam. All right, so you're all going to make your way up to Mother. So you guys head up the stairs, and you make your way out into the hallway. And as you're rounding the corner to head towards Mother, you see a body slumped up against the far wall as you're making your way down the hallway. The body's different from other corpses that you've seen aboard. It's ravaged and decayed. Unlike the ravaged and decayed skeletal remains you found of others, this is a woman, and she's whole. Lying is slumped up against the hallway.
No. Nope. Whatever your instincts are, don't do it. Nope.
Ava. That's Ava. That's one of our crew.
If you want to stay out here with
she
Ava, be
she's
our
a
guest.
Synth. That's why she didn't go into cryo. He rushes over and he starts looking her over. He lifts up her head. He starts feeling around the back of her head. And as he does so and he pulls her head back, there's like this slick, sticky, milky substance back there.
Is she like gone or is she coherent?
He looks at the group and he goes, she's got a nasty head wound, but we could try to repair her. Get
drag
her back
her
online
with mother,
to see
then.
What happened.
If she's a synth, then that's better than a human, because that means she can't turn into an alien, right?
No, she can't.
Right, but she might go psycho crazy, though. I don't know.
Well, we've seen two humans tonight go psycho crazy. Well, three if you include myself.
Lucas, what do you think? Is this a wise idea?
I think you need all of us that you can have.
I'm going to read something off the synth sheet for all of you guys as well. It's illegal to program an android for violence against humans.
Oh.
So while modern synthetics are governed by behavioral inhibitors that prevent them from injuring others, earlier models are not so equipped and therefore dangerous. Expensive bypass packages are available on the black market, blah, 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 blah. So, if an android goes too long without scheduled maintenance, it can also begin to experience mental degradation and onset of psychosis. But you don't know that. So as far as you know, synths are typically, okay, they're programmed to not harm humans.
Okay.
They're not all right. Ash. They're not out to kill you.
Let's drag her with us into Mother's room and we'll try and fix her.
So you guys, yeah, drag her into Mother's room and you can make a comtech roll on her to try and get her back online. Ava.
Lucas, are you still good at those?
What's the harm?
Lucas.
I can do it.
From one synth to another.
I'm gonna walk over kind of hesitantly and just kind of break out my tools and say, well, if you need help.
I can always use help.
Can I do the, it says, I don't know if this is just in combat, like the different options for command. This is like, it's in combat. Never mind, just kidding.
Look at this. You guys, it feels a little weird calling Rye Lucas also. You're kind of like, Lucas?
Hey, I'm all on board.
Because you've known her as Rye for so long. So, Rye, you get down there and you start working on Ava. You know exactly what to do to get this synth back online. When you do so, all of a sudden, she starts kind of coughing, gurgling. This milky substance comes out of her mouth. And she looks around the room. She's got short black hair. And her eyes open up and she looks around. And she's like, she introduces herself. Hello, I am Ava. Hello, Flynn. How are the others? Who are these people?
I'm your new captain. Nice to meet you. My name is Vanessa Miller.
I see. Have you encountered the creatures?
Yes, we fought one.
The Neomorphs. Have you encountered the Abominations yet?
Yes. I think.
If by Abomination you mean the big old monster things running
around. Did you take the inoculation?
Yeah.
Then I fear your time is limited. You will become one of the Abominations with time.
Shit.
Fuck. Is there any cure?
There is. anyone who's been. No, she says. No, there is a chance to resist, but there is no cure. There is also the presence of Agent AO3959X.91-15 on board, a rare artifact that Clayton wants taken back, but it is actually a deadly weapon.
Okay.
A deadly weapon that can kill these aliens, or this is something on a larger scale?
It is the aliens. The corporation wants this to use it and weaponize it.
That doesn't seem very good, does it, Wilson?
I don't know what she's talking about.
Do you not know what she's talking about, Wilson?
It doesn't matter now. What are we going to do? Walk home?
I'm just curious. Did you know about this the whole time?
No.
Can I see if he's lying?
Wilson, are you lying?
Is Wilson lying?
Let's see here. Do you want to? You can roll, Miller. You want to do a? I don't know. Observation roll.
I'm doing observation.
He's sweating a little bit.
Oh.
You can't tell. He's like, I don't know. He's playing coy, and you can't tell. You can push it if you want. You gonna push that roll?
What do I get if I push it? I gain stress.
You gain stress, and you can try to see if Wilson's lying.
I don't give a shit anymore. No, I'm not pushing it. Yes. Well, whether you knew or not, I guess it is irrelevant, like you're saying, because we are all fucked, apparently, because we all injected ourselves.
Well, Ava says, we must try to stop these creatures, and I will also put you out of your misery when the time comes.
But you said we could try to resist. Is there any way to increase our chances of resisting?
Well, I'll tell you what. We're going to find out in Act 3 because that is the end of Act 1, meeting Ada the Synth and learning that you are now all infected who took the shots. It's funny, when we played it, none of us took the damn shots. We're like, I ain't putting that in my body.
What could go wrong?
Yeah, I'm the dumbass that was just like, look, everybody, it's all right. No big deal.
So that is the end of Act 2. We'll come back next week Tuesday with Act 3, the finale, and we'll finish this thing. We'll wrap it up. Shit got real this week.
Yeah, it did.
Real quick.
It got real. It got real numerous times.
I like how the players got stressed for real playing this.
Yeah, I'm serious, though. It felt like Pandemic, where you're sitting there rolling over and over and over again for outbreaks, and they keep triggering each other, and there's like this big contingency of outbreaks. It's exactly what it felt like. It was like, oh, sweet. One person panic, causing us to panic. Then they may cause me to hit 10, which caused everyone else to panic some more.
Yeah.
That
was good. All right. I love it. I love being in the driver's seat for this now, too, and seeing how you guys play differently than when we did it.
Yeah, we're a little more easy going with
you
taking
guys are cautious
taking,
also,
things.
Other than just putting stuff in your veins. Yeah. Otherwise, you're way more cautious.
Yeah.
And your company man's not as crooked and working against you like ours did.
Yeah, Oak.
I'm following company procedure so far.
There you go. There you go. And you now have a synth in your, not just Ada, you've got a synth in your presence.
Yeah.
We're dead.
Not all of us.
Like, the company man is so cocky. Oh, so good. All right, so that's the end of Act 2. Back next week, and I don't know if we're game. Well, I don't know what's happening on Friday yet, but Saturday is Mutant Year Zero. So tune in for that ongoing Mutant Year Zero game. Thank you, everybody, who joined us for Session 2, Act 2 this week. It was a lot of fun,
that was cool.
Yeah, we'll wrap it up next week. Have a good night, everyone.
Good night.
Yeah. Awesome. Good night.